Welcome to Stillwater. We're at the beginning of the season. Everybody in the Big 12 was talking about TCU.
That's right.
Talking about Baylor. But the Oklahoma State Cowboys sat in the weeds led by their coach, Mike Gundy, who, in my opinion, is the National Coach of the Year. And right now they're undefeated and ready to make a serious run.
He's definitely going to have a case for that National Coach of the Year. There's no doubt. And it's been an improbable season for Oklahoma State because it's been an improbable roster for Mike Gundy. 10-0. They've won 12 straight football games going back to the end of last year, including a bedlam victory over Oklahoma in which a true freshman got his very first win. Mason Rudolph as a quarterback. That was only his second start of his career. He's won 12 in a row, but he gets a huge help from a senior and a leader in J.W. Walsh. This two-quarterback system has worked to perfection for Mike Gundy so far this year.
As for Baylor, they're coming off their first loss of the season last week at home to Oklahoma. Their quarterback is a true freshman. He's been putting up great numbers since replacing Seth Russell, but he comes into this game with a tender back.
He does, and that back was hurt on the third play of the game against OU last week. He fought through it, wasn't as effective as they'd like him to be, but here's a guy with immense talent, in particular throwing the ball down the field. I expect Baylor to be very aggressive down the field with their great wide receiver, Corey Coleman, and this game is going to come down to the right arm of Jarrett Stidham from Baylor.
This is the first AP Top 10 matchup here since 1985. Baylor hasn't won at Stillwater since 1939. Oklahoma State Cowboys took the field. 10-0, 7-0 in the Big 12, ready to take on the Baylor Bears. And welcome back to Fox College Football, presented by K Jewelers. We've got a hot one for you tonight. Oklahoma State and Baylor. And time now to join the third member of our team on the sideline. Here's Molly McGrath.
Well, Gus, you mentioned it. Jarrett Stidham playing through a back injury, but he told me football is all about managing distractions. And the pain in my back, just a distraction. This game is bigger than some pain. Stidham admitted that he was still sore during the week, but wasn't in any pain during pregame warmups. He had no special treatment on his back today, but it is really cold down here, guys. Corey Coleman told me that weather won't be a factor, but he is wearing new gloves that are much thicker than normal, and Baylor has heaters, heated benches, and heated blankets on their sideline. They also have hot chocolate and some chicken broth to keep their players warm and hydrated on this cold Oklahoma night, guys.
All right, Molly, thank you very much. Perfect weather for a college football game. It's cold, folks. 35 degrees. The temperature is supposed to dip into the 20s. Baylor won the toss, and the Bears elected to receive the football. This is a series that dates back to 1914. Oklahoma State leads it 19-14 and has won 16 of the last 19. And as I mentioned before, Baylor hasn't won in Stillwater since 1939.
Now they got the true freshman, Jarrett Stidham, who's going to try to break that trend. What an amazing atmosphere here for college football late in November.
So Zamara and Chris Platt back deep for the Bears. Baylor coming off their first loss of the season, 44-34 in Waco to OU. Oklahoma State beat Iowa State 35-31 on the road last week. They had to come back to do it. Ben Grogan will send it away. And here we go. Baylor, OK State. This is Platt from the six. Trying to find the edge, turns the corner. And he'll go out of bounds around the 35-yard line. So as the Bears take the field on offense, couple of things to pay attention to when they have the ball.
Corey Coleman has been the most productive receiver in the country so far this season, and yet he was very quiet a week ago against a group of very good corners from Oklahoma. Oklahoma State has corners that can equal the Sooners, in particular Kevin Peterson, who's one of the best in the Big 12. Look for him to shadow Coleman most of the night. It's a matchup that should be fantastic.
First down and 10 at the 36 for young Jarrett Stidham. True freshman, 19 years old from Stephenville, Texas. Baylor has started every game this season with a touchdown on their opening drive. Stidham down the sideline. Whoa! He dropped it in, Corey Coleman, and he's down at the 15. George Martin Stearns makes the saving tackle, but it's a gain of 58.
Last week, they got way too enamored with running the football on first down. Kendall Briles told us he wanted to be aggressive early. First play of the game, first down.
And they'll run it now. Shock Linwood straight ahead. And he gets to the 10. Chad Whitener with the tackle. Hurry up offense being applied by the Bears. Second and 5 of the 11. And once again, it's Linwood. He'll pick up the first down. What did you see in that game last week for Baylor against OU?
They were a bit hard-headed with their run game. They wanted to run it on first down. They didn't take the shots necessary to open up their run game. Now they open the game with a shot down the field. They complete it to Coleman, and guess what? Run it a couple of times for a first down, and here we go. All of a sudden, they've been balanced.
First down and goal at the 5. Opening drive for Baylor. Here's a handoff, Linwood. How simple can it get? Baylor storming down the field, scoring in 4 plays to take a 6-0 lead on the road here at Oklahoma State.
Well, I'll say Jared Stidham's healthy. I know he only had to throw one pass, but it was absolutely perfect to Coleman, and Shock Linwood did the rest of the work with some help from those big guys up front. Those offensive linemen opening up an enormous hole. Linwood walks in for 6.
And last week against Oklahoma, Linwood 21 carries, 103 yards as Chris Callahan comes in to attempt the extra point. And it's good. Linwood with his 10th rushing touchdown of the season. And Baylor making a statement early. They're ready to ball here in Stillwater. Covering 64 yards, scoring in less than a minute to take the 7-0 lead. It's some early game headlines.
Well, Florida in the top 10, but struggling into overtime with FAU. They will assuredly, if the committee has any integrity, drop out of the top 10. Iowa clinched the Big Ten West. Frank Beamer almost won his last home game. I don't think there was anyone outside of the state of North Carolina that was rooting against Virginia Tech there at the end. What a career Frank Beamer has had. Just a tip of the cap from this booth to Frank Beamer for what he's done for college football.
Spencer Everett's ready to send it away. Jeff Carr, Chris Lacy back deep. And this will be Chris Lacy from the 10-yard line. And he advances the ball to the 25 before being brought down. So a couple of things to pay attention to when Oklahoma State has the football.
This conference is all about wide receivers, and Oklahoma State has a huge depth of core of wide receivers. James Washington is their leader. 8 players with 2 TD catches or more, and they're going up against a defense that's very banged up. 2 safeties that'll be brand new today in Chance Waz, Orion Stewart, both injured. Terrence Singleton, Teon Sells in the ballgame. They'll be tested early.
First down and 10 of the 26. Carson lining up as a single setback behind Mason Rudolph. And delayed handoff. Not a lot of room for Chris Carson. But how about Mason Rudolph, 6'4", sophomore from Rock Hill, South Carolina. Coach Gundy last year went to him when he was a true freshman redshirt and says, hey, do you want to play a redshirt? Rudolph said, I want to play. Gundy, okay, then you're the starter. That was it, and the rest is history. Second down and 8 at the 28. And this time it's Shepard running right. And Brandon Shepard lost the ball. Baylor says they have it. Running toward the end zone, no call yet. Touchdown, Baylor. Grant Campbell picked it up and sprinted into the end zone.
Everyone on the field except for Campbell ended up stopping. Having a hard time seeing why he just
stripped
it right out.
Ruling on the field was a fumble recovered by the defense for a touchdown.
Campbell just ripped it right away. That ball looked like it was coming loose before Shepard was actually on the ground. I'm shocked that Shepard
was a fumble recovered by the defense for a touchdown. Previous play is now under further review.
Shocked that Shepard didn't get up and try to tackle Campbell. It was coming away from his body. Ripped it out just like Maurice Claret in that national championship game way back in 2002. Hard to see if that knee was down.
All right, let's join our rules analyst from Los Angeles, Mike Pereira.
Well, I'll tell you, as we're looking at it here, you get a quick shot that shows that the knee's down and the right hand is still on the ball. It looks to me a shade before it starts moving. If I'm in replay, I think I put him down here. You're going to see the knee hit, and now then the ball gets pulled out. If you actually stop it when the knee is down and take a look at it at that point, looks to me like he's down.
And Mike, even if they don't overturn this, it looked like Campbell's knee was down as he rolled over after he stripped the ball, and that right knee was down. So regardless of if this stands as a fumble or not, it clearly will not be a touchdown. Correct, Mike?
That is for sure, because anything other than the hand or foot, and his back is down, his head is down. So if they deem that the ball's coming out before that knee was on the ground, or they don't feel that they have enough evidence to overturn, then they'll put him down there.
Going to be such a tough call for these officials up in the replay booth. Mike, I tend to see what you're seeing, but it's so close, it's hard to come to that term, indisputable.
And here we go with the call.
After review, the runner was down prior to losing possession of the ball.
So
it'll be third down and three at the 33-yard line.
So
clock operator, please reset the game clock to 13:28.
So, Oklahoma State catches a break. They'll be faced with a third down and three at the 33. Thank you very much, Mike Pereira.
As always, right on top of it, isn't he?
Yep. But already, Baylor on both sides of the ball coming out and playing with a ferocity after last week's loss to Oklahoma.
An energy that we didn't see even at home against OU last week. And this defense needs it. They need something good to happen early with all the backups in. They're also missing Bo Blackshear, a defensive tackle, in this ball game. So having to be very creative with their lineup. A lot of guys that are inexperienced on the field right now defensively for the Baylor Bears.
So third down and three at the 33 for Mason Rudolph. In his last four games, he's been completing 67% of his passes, averaging 317 yards per game. He'll throw it on third and short to the sideline, and incomplete. Dangerous throw, as David Glidden was the intended receiver. So Oklahoma State will punt it away.
Really good coverage from Trevon Blanchard, number 48. He was a linebacker that was coming out underneath that route. Because of his defense, I thought that forced Rudolph to throw the ball higher than he wanted to. Terrific read. That's what happens on third down.
Zach Seiner, who's been having a wonderful year, back to punt at his own 18-yard line. Links Hawthorne back deep at the 20. Seiner driving it, and it's fair caught at the 22. 7-0 the score. Corey Coleman, one of the best in the nation, back on the field right after this. IK Jewelers is sponsored by Budweiser. Make a plan to make it home. 7-0 Baylor. There's Mike Gundy. A year ago, what a difference a year makes. The student newspaper was saying that maybe he wasn't enjoying coaching. Maybe he wasn't the man for the job. Now he's got this team undefeated and ready to possibly compete in the college football playoff if they can finish off strong.
And with the second longest win streak in the FBS, with Ohio State going down, Houston going down, now Iowa, and this Oklahoma State team right in there.
First down and 10, Chuck Linwood running. And Linwood crossing the 25 up to the 27, Jordan Stearns defensively. What is it about this kid?
He doesn't flinch. His eyes don't become too big, even as a true freshman. Doesn't matter what the rush is doing, even when he got injured.
And how about this? Some deception and a first down as Shock Linwood grabs it and goes. Jared Stidham sold it perfectly.
He was walking over to the sideline when that ball was snapped. I don't know if it, I think that was absolutely a planned deal, but the snap was way too high for Linwood.
But a first down. Here's Stidham to throw. Stidham looking sideline. Gets it up and incomplete. Corey Coleman, the intended receiver.
And there's that matchup Coleman and Kevin Peterson. Peterson, just great talent as a corner. They were in a zone coverage on that first completion down the field. That's why he wasn't step for step. But in that last play in man coverage, you can tell Coleman's not going to get much separation from Kevin Peterson.
Second down and 10 at the 35. Johnny Jefferson in at running back now for Baylor. Here's Johnny Jefferson running straight ahead. And he'll plow his way to the 40-yard line. Make it the 41. So Stidham, last week against Oklahoma, playing through that tender back, 16 of 27, 257, two touchdowns. Now Stidham throwing on the move. He's got a receiver. Katie Canny down the sideline. Touchdown, Bears. 59 yards.
Oklahoma State big on the double move. Watch Stidham come out to his right, and he's going to fake, and he's going to pump it right there. The safety draws up, and then all of a sudden, Katie Cannon bursts down the field. Excellent play design from Kendall Briles, the offensive coordinator, for a touchdown, and the explosive Bears are back. Didn't see much of that last week, and now they are taking shots on early downs here at Oklahoma State.
Chris Callahan in to attempt the extra point. And remember, folks, Jared Stidham is a true freshman. He's 19, but you won't see a quarterback in college football throw a prettier ball than this young man. And he's got some weapons on the outside. Baylor up big early.
Their way back up to that top four. I tell you, with Ohio State losing, they still are looking for their first top 25 win. And if Baylor's able to win here tonight in Stillwater, their resume would look awful good next to the Ohio State Buckeyes.
Spencer Evans sends it away. Jeff Carr back deep. And that one bobbled, but Oklahoma State recovering at the 22-yard line. So let's take a look at the top 10. Clemson still the number one team in the nation.
Clemson's done a heck of a job. Obviously, Charleston Southern, no match for Alabama, even if they were the 8th-ranked team in the FCS. Iowa with a nice win, but this Oklahoma State team obviously can move up and make ground if they can come back. And Baylor and Michigan State going to make ground. Again, I believe wholeheartedly Florida will come down. Ohio State probably come down to about 9 or 10.
First down and 10 at the 23 for Oklahoma State. Rudolph fires. This one caught by McCleskey. And he'll get out of bounds at the 26. Remember, Oklahoma State has 5 come from behind victories this season. Central Michigan, Texas, Kansas State, Texas Tech. And they also did it last week against Iowa State. 2nd and 6. Play fake. Rudolph, far side. On the move. Washington, first down, Cowboys.
They've got that no-flinch mentality that I was speaking of with Jared Stidham. Well, Mason Rudolph also has that. They had a 17-point deficit last week, came back, won the ball game on the road.
First down and 10, Raymond Taylor in the backfield. Here's Rudolph again under pressure and incomplete. Washington, closest man to the football. X Howard defensively for Baylor.
They were down 17 3 different times against Texas Tech. They've had 15-point deficits and won in 3 different games. They did not have the lead with a minute remaining. This team will not panic, even if they're looking across the line of scrimmage at a top 10 Baylor team that's got a 14-point lead.
Second down and 10 of the 35. Rudolph steps up in the pocket and is tripped up. Terrific job by Taylor Young, the sophomore out of DeSoto, Texas.
The 2014 Big 12 Defensive Newcomer of the Year as a freshman a year ago. He's short, only 5'10", 225 pounds, but a great motor. And he's got terrific football instincts, off balance, still dives at the ankles and is able to get Mason Rudolph to the ground.
So that makes it 3rd down and 14 at the 31. Oklahoma State needs to get to the 45 for first down. Rudolph delivers down the field. He's got his receiver, Aikman. Got it! At the 32. What a beautiful ball by Mason Rudolph. And Marcel Aikman just gobbled it up.
And now they're looking to go with tempo after the big play.
A gain of 38. And they'll run it. Chris Carson straight ahead. Grant Campbell defensively for Baylor.
Marcel Aikman picking up right where he left off a week ago. Logged a career high last week against Iowa State in that comeback. 8 catches for 132 yards. He was an absolute beast. Had a touchdown as well. Coming into his own, a 6'4 target, 210 pounds, junior from Dallas, Texas.
All 5 of his career touchdown catches have come this season. 2nd and 7 at the 28. Play fake. Rudolph all day. Sideline. Incomplete. Intended for Austin Hayes.
Chance Waz on the coverage, number 18. He's been dealing with a neck injury. Left the game last week against Oklahoma, but great coverage here. Right on the hip pocket. Didn't interfere with the wide receiver down the field. That's just excellent coverage, forcing a longer third down opportunity.
So 3rd down and 7 now, the 28. Waz from Pflugerville, Texas. Trips at the top of your screen. Glidden has been a go-to receiver on third downs during his career. Rudolph looking up top for Aikman. And he's got it at the 10. And a 1st down, Oklahoma State. X Howard had to hold on to his ankle.
Well, they brought the house, everybody, which means man-man coverage on the outside and some hand fighting. They don't call the penalty. Aikman maybe gets away with that little arm bar there with the left arm and comes back and basically catches that ball one-handed. This guy's having a sensational couple of games.
A gain of 18. J.W. Walsh in the game now at quarterback for Oklahoma State.
The previous play was a completed pass. Previous play is now under further review.
They want to see exactly if that ball was secured before he stepped out. That left arm was definitely still fighting with Xavier Howard. He's clearly inbounds, but you see there's some bobbling going on. They want to see if that's secure. He wasn't out of bounds until that right foot hits. Tough to tell exactly when he secured the ball, but it's going to be a great look. It looks pretty secure there. Now there's a little bobble, and then it's secure right when that right foot comes down. It was actually that opposite hand, that right hand, that eventually secured the ball.
I don't know, Joel. Sometimes I think we are a little bit too precise. That's a catch.
There's no question it's a catch. And I think I speak for everybody at home as we bring in Mike Pereira. Mike, I think every football fan, whether it's NFL or college, is getting a little confused on what's a catch and what's not a catch.
Well, I think we're scrutinizing everything so close, looking for slight movement of the ball. Here they're going to look to see if his left hand slid off the ball, and then the right hand came back on the ball with the left foot still down. I agree with Gus. It just seems like we begin to almost over officiate the play in replay. And to me, this has some elements that are close. But let's remember, in replay, the standard in college is supposed to be, it has to be beyond a shadow of a doubt that the call was incorrect to reverse. And to me, this is close, but I'd leave it as it is.
Mike, do you think it's a little overzealous to even stop it when it clearly is a catch? And by the spirit of the rule, he brought it down, he secured it and was in bounds. Are they looking too hard for that bobble?
Well, I mean, it's something they always look, they call it for, they're looking for smoke. That's what they say. If you see any smoke, if you see a defender give an incomplete pass signal.
After review, the ruling on the field stands as a completed pass.
So Aikman with 2 big third down catches. Thank you very much, Mike Pereira. Oklahoma State now with the football inside the Baylor 10-yard line.
What a weapon Aikman is in those one-on-one situations, and this is the point of the field. Even with J.W. Walsh, it's not solely a run package with Walsh. They will throw it, and Aikman's got the matchup on the near side of your screen.
Had a hand in all 3 of the team's second-half touchdowns last week, rushing for 2 of them and completing a 7-yard touchdown pass. J.W. Walsh. And he hands it off to Jeff Carr around the corner. And Carr leaned forward and get to the 3-yard line. A 6-yard pickup.
They've been so effective with J.W. Walsh coming in the game in these red zone opportunities, these scoring zone opportunities. And one of the things that makes this two-quarterback system effective is the fact that the players believe in him. He's a leader, he's a senior, and they play hard for number 4.
The old team in the Big 12 is more effective in the red zone than Oklahoma State. Second and goal at the 3. J.W. Walsh. McCleskey. Touchdown. Great deception by the Cowboys. Oklahoma State has converted 94% of its trips into either a touchdown or field goal in the red zone.
Watch the entire movement for Oklahoma State is going to the right, and just a little flip to McCleskey, and he's able to get into the end zone easily because everyone carried out the fake to the right side.
Ben Grogan in to attempt the extra point. And it's good. High scoring affair in the first quarter. All right, folks, Joel Klatt picks his top 50 draft prospects in the Fox 50 on foxsports.com/Fox50. Emmanuel Ogba is in the Fox 50 and considered one of the nation's top defensive linemen. The Fox 50 is sponsored by Sprint. Visit sprint.com/save 50% to learn more. All right, Joel, what is this all about?
Well, this guy, Emmanuel Ogba, there's an NFL franchise that is going to get an absolute diamond. Plays hard, and he does everything right off the field. This guy is one of the most talented players in the Big 12. He gets after the passer, which the NFL desperately needs. And like I said, one of the highest character players that we've got going on right now in college football.
All right, Baylor will start. Zamara looking for a lane and gets one at the 30 and all the way up to the 36-yard line. Let's go to Jenny Taft in the studio for a Lowe's game break.
Thanks, Gus. Number 16, Navy visiting Tulsa. How about Toneil Goley, who would take this one 70 yards for the touchdown? The midshipman now up 14-0 in the second quarter as Navy needs to keep winning to play in a New Year's Six bowl game. Gus, Joel, back to you guys.
All right, Navy 8-1, ranked 16th in the nation.
And Keenan Reynolds, I tell you, he might get some late run. The Navy quarterback, he's scored 81 rushing touchdowns in his career, breaking Monty Ball's FBS record.
First down and 10, Shock Linwood looking for a hole, and he won't find one here. As Chad Whitener comes up and makes the play.
Yeah, it's very clear that early in the downs, early in the series, Baylor needs to throw the ball to open up that defense to get the run game going later.
Second and 8 at the 38. Play fake. Stidham delivers a strike. KD Cannon again. And I'll tell you what, with KD Cannon, Corey Coleman, Jay Lee, Lynx Hawthorne, I mean, can you find a better group of receivers in the nation?
Well, you know, in this game as a whole, Oklahoma State's got a great core of wide receivers as well, but this Baylor core of wide receivers is explosive.
First down and 10 at the 48-yard line, Linwood again. Miley with the tackle for the Cowboys.
This offense has just been so prolific. First in points, total yards, yards per play in the FBS, and they're at it again tonight.
Here's a handoff to Linwood. And Linwood will gain about 4 yards on the play. Seth Jacobs with the tackle. Great atmosphere. We're in Stillwater, Oklahoma, folks. One of the biggest games of the day. The Baylor Bears still smarting from the loss last week at home to Oklahoma. They would love nothing more than to spoil things for Oklahoma State coming into this game undefeated. Third down and 4 at the 42. Stidham looking. Stidham, he's got a receiver up top. Incomplete. Chris Platt, the intended receiver. That brings up fourth down.
Great coverage. Oklahoma State gambled a bit. They went with man coverage, brought the pressure. Stidham still threw a great ball, but Chris Platt was unable to adjust to it. It was a good route. It was right on the left side, but he was unable to get out there, and Baylor's going to keep their offense on the field, go for it on fourth down.
And Stidham, good pooch punt it. Fourth down and 4. And he'll throw it. Stidham to the sideline. Incomplete. No flag on the play. Terrific job defensively. Corey Coleman, the intended receiver. Ashton Lampkin sat on him. And Baylor turns it over on downs.
Baylor was looking for a pass interference here on Ashton Lampkin. Watch here as Coleman tries to slow play it, and then there's some contact there late. That ball was awful high. I don't know if that was all that catchable, but Art Briles looking for the flag. He's still looking. No laundry on the ground.
So Oklahoma State starts with great field position at their own 42. Rennie Childs checks in at running back. Rudolph over the middle, has a wide open man. The catch made by Zach Veach, the redshirt junior from Broken Arrow, Oklahoma. It's a 19-yard pickup. Play fake again. Rudolph going for it. Oh!
Touchdown! The president, James Washington, 39 yards.
It's a game of inches. Ryan Reed, number 9, almost tipped that ball away before Washington ended up with 6.
And the extra point is good. Buckle up, folks. We're in store for possibly a classic. Oklahoma State, Baylor. Tee to peace, James Washington. In consecutive weeks against Texas Tech and TCU, he had 9 catches for 384 yards. He's had 4 100-yard games in his last 6. This kid from Stamford, Texas is starting to come on. 2 plays, 58 yards for Oklahoma State. The Cowboys scoring in 19 seconds. Grogan sends it away. Chris Platt, the returner. And Platt taken down as he crosses the 25-yard line.
The momentum in this game has just completely shifted. Baylor could not have a better start than what they had on the first 3 total possessions in this game. They went down for a quick score. They got a stop. Then they went for another quick score. But ever since then, it's been all Oklahoma State. Remember, this is a team that is very used to playing with a deficit, this Oklahoma State team. It doesn't bother them. They just stick with their game.
Scrambling. Throws on the move. And he'll dump it out of play. Now, Art Briles really praised Mike Gundy and his team. He said, whatever their personnel is, they always play within themselves. You see them in all types of games, and they never panic. They always have poise, and they believe in their system. And that all goes back to Coach Gundy. 2nd and 10 at the 27. Stidham steps up in the pocket, trying to buy time. Stidham tripped up at the 30-yard line. Chad Whitener, who's been having a terrific season, the redshirt sophomore from Mansfield, Texas.
And that roster you were just speaking of, Mike Gundy does find success. All these transfers, you've got guys like Chad Whitener, a transfer from Cal.
Here's Stidham. Throws. Stidham looking and caught by KD Cannon. Stidham standing strong in the pocket, Joel.
This guy just does not flinch. Pressure right in his face, and he delivers a beautiful ball right down the field to KD Cannon, who's one of the fastest players in this conference.
And another big play for the Baylor offense, which came into tonight's game. Leading the Big 12 with 78 plays of 20 yards or longer. That's their 3rd big play tonight. First down, a gain of 42. Stidham looking underneath, and Coleman took his eyes off it. Corey Coleman, rare mistake by this All-America.
This offensive line has done a heck of a job, because even though there's been some pressure on Stidham, he's been clean for the most part. Guys like Pat Colbert at right tackle, Spencer Drango, a guy in my Fox 50 at left tackle who's got an amazing matchup tonight against Emmanuel Ogba, number 38. Another guy in my Fox 50. Two first-round caliber players going at it tonight.
Second and 10 at the 28-yard line. And Stidham going for the long ball again on a run. Incomplete. Coleman, the intended receiver, Kevin Peterson, blanketing him.
This guy's technique is just impeccable. See how he runs right in the hip, and then as soon as the wide receiver raises his hand to catch the ball, where do his hands go? Right between them. That is textbook defensive back play. That guy is a sensational player.
Third down and 10 at the 28. Stidham, deep in the pocket, throws off his back foot, a spiral, incomplete. Out of bounds, KD Cannon, the intended receiver, but Kevin Peterson right there. And I tell you what, these DBs, the corners, Ashton Lampkin, Kevin Peterson, are terrific athletes.
Well, okay, he wasn't even covering that route, and he still got to the spot. That's how athletic he is, Gus. I mean, Peterson at 5'11", 190 pounds, doesn't have prototype size, but he falls back under that route beautifully to break it up from KD Cannon.
Tim Duffy, the defensive backs coach, always has these guys prepared. A 45-yard attempt for Chris Callahan. And he hooked it. 5:13 to play, first quarter. 14 apiece. Baylor, Oklahoma State.
This Cowboys team has done a remarkable job of swinging the momentum and getting this crowd in the game here in the first quarter. Baylor all over them early, but this defense has really bowed its neck in the last couple of series. That's what they do. That's what Mike Gundy has prided himself on with this unit. Trailed in the second half, 5 of the 10 games that they've played. Trailed with a minute remaining in 3 games, Texas, Kansas State, and West Virginia. And they've trailed by 15 or more points in 3 games this season.
First down and 10 at the 28-yard line for the Cowboys. Rudolph will hand it off to Raymond Taylor. Taylor goes backwards. He got blasted by Sean Oakman. And folks, if you ever have a chance to stand next to Sean Oakman, you'll see one of the best-looking athletes you'll ever see. 6'9", 275.
This guy is just a physical freak. He's fast, he's powerful, he's long. See how play on the sun come all the way around, still make the play.
Second down and 12 after the 2-yard loss at the 26. Rudolph, he'll throw it. Steps into his throw, underneath the hands, Washington. Again, Washington picked up the first down, then went backwards. So let's see where they spot it.
He willingly went backwards to reestablish a different upfield spot. At this point, now he's a runner, and at this point he willingly goes back. Now he's contacted, and the linesman does a heck of a job spotting that back short of the first down, a mistake from James Washington.
Third down and 1. And Walsh in the game looking for the first down, and he's chopped down. He will not get it. Edwards coming up and making the tackle. Avion Edwards, the junior from Stephenville. And Oklahoma State with a decision to make. Now remember, Oklahoma State is the only team in the country that is perfect on fourth down this year. Although the Cowboys have only gone for it 6 times.
We're going to take a look at this, it seems like, but from our vantage point up here, and I know we're on the roof, Gus, but it looks about a half yard short. Boy, how big of a mistake now is that reestablishment of field position by James Washington. Had the first down, and now it looks like it's going to be about a half yard short.
But Joel, why would you even think about it going for it on fourth down at your own 37-yard line?
Well, this is when a coach could possibly be a prisoner of the moment. You know, the momentum, the crowd. But the prudent thing to do here is absolutely kick the ball away, in particular with how well the defense has been playing here in the last couple of series. But J.W. Walsh will trot back onto the field in the short yardage package for Mike Gundy.
Let's see if he tries to draw Baylor offside. Walsh in the shotgun. Fourth down and one. That's exactly what they did. Baylor not eating the cheese. So now they will bring the punt team on. Timeout, Oklahoma State, 3:14 to go. First quarter from Stillwater, 14 apiece. Bring their punter on, Zach Seiner. And back deep, Lynx Hawthorne for the Bears. Nice spiraling punt. Hawthorne with the fair catch at the 17. Next week is rivalry week in college football, and we'll bring you plenty of bad blood, including Texas Tech versus Texas, Washington against Washington State for the Apple Cup, and the Civil War between Oregon State and Oregon. It all begins Thanksgiving Day on FS1 and here on Fox. And I'll tell you what, nobody in the country wants to play Oregon right now.
Man, you ain't lying. This team with Vernon Adams, heck of a performance today. They played USC. They're still alive. Of course, Stanford's going to play Cal later tonight in that ball game, that rivalry ball game. Stanford will lock up the Pac-12 North with a win. But Oregon on their heels, the offensive leaders, already a big day here offensively for both teams. But Baylor needs to get a little momentum back. They haven't had it the majority of the last 10 minutes.
First down and 10 of the 17. Stidham, delayed handoff, Linwood. And Linwood will go down at the 22-yard line. Vincent Taylor, redshirt sophomore from San Antonio, with the tackle.
Excellent job here. This design they're pulling around is actually the tackle. That was big Spencer Drango leading up there for a big game.
Gain of five. Second down, Linwood again. Jitterbugging. And shock Linwood will gain three. Third and two. Linwood again looking for the first down, and he has it. As he's dragged down at the 32-yard line by Jordan Burton.
Good vision there from Linwood. Had to stop, find the seam, and then he was able to burst upfield for the first down.
14 career 100-yard games for Linwood. Stidham. He wants to run it. And Stidham tackled from behind. Agba tracking him after the 4-yard pickup.
An entire coaching staff and all the Baylor fans, whenever Stidham is on the run, Kendall Briles, their heart's going to be in their throat. Remember, dealing with a back injury from last week.
Stidham to throw it again. Looking. Now dancing out of the pocket. Nobody home. So Stidham takes it himself and gets out of bounds at the 41.
He missed his guy, Corey Coleman. Corey Coleman's just going to run a curl route, and he was wide open right here. He's clapping his hands, comes to the open spot, and then shows a little frustration that he didn't get the ball.
First down, though, at the 43. Corey Coleman lining up in the backfield. And they'll give it to him. The speedster, midfield. Coleman trying to get outside. And Coleman still on his feet as he finally is taken down inside Cowboy territory.
Last week, only three catches. He wasn't able to affect the game. Kendall Briles said that we got to get him the ball whatever way we can, whether it's in the pass game or the run game, here lined up as a running back.
He picked up 15 yards there. It was double and triple teamed at times last week against Oklahoma.
False start. Offense. Number 61. 5-yard penalty. First down.
Jarrell Broxton, the senior from Maryland, a junior college transfer from Lackawanna College. Happens to be the same junior college that Kevin White was at before he went to West Virginia, and then, of course, now is a top 10 pick with the Chicago Bears.
First penalty of the game. First down and 15 for Stidham. Sidestepping underneath. Oh, he threw a missile at the 30-yard line, and it's caught by Lynx Hawthorne. This kid has intangibles.
I tell you, that's great arm strength. Watch him off balance, and he's still able to get the ball into what I think is a tight window for a first down. terrific arm talent from the youngster.
5 for 12, 180 yards and a touchdown. Here's the handoff to Johnny Jefferson. And J.J. will get that football down to the 25.
You see how having success in the passing game has opened up the run later in the series.
Second and six at the 26. Stidham. And it's caught. This time it's Zamora. Ishmael Zamora with a 5-yard pickup. Third and one.
This tempo has been very fast from Baylor so far.
Jefferson looking for the first down, and he has it. As Baylor gets the ball close to the Oklahoma State 15-yard line. With 21 seconds remaining, Baylor runs a play every 19.4 seconds. That's the quickest tempo in the Big 12.
Last week, I thought they slowed down a bit. There was way too much looking over the sideline. You can clearly see part of their game plan to go fast tonight.
First down and 10 at the 18. Stidham over the middle. Caught Corey Coleman at the 3. First down. Jordan Stearns with the tackle. And that should take us to the end of the first quarter. But I don't know. It's Baylor. It may not. They get a playoff. Jefferson. And Johnny Jefferson did not make it into the end zone. And that'll take us to the end of the first quarter. Game tied at 14. But the Baylor Bears knocking on the door at the Oklahoma State 1 when we come back. Bears, Joel, 294 yards of offense in the first quarter.
I mean, some teams be desperate for 294 yards in a game, much less the first quarter. They snapped it 33 times, averaging 8.9 yards per play.
Second down and goal at the Oklahoma State 1-yard line. Devin Chafin is checked in at running back. And he goes straight ahead for a touchdown. So Baylor marching it right down the field. 13-play drive, covering 83 yards. And the Bears score in 3 minutes and 9 seconds.
They had some big plays wrapped in there, there's no question, but that was pretty methodical. You know, this feels like a heavyweight fight right now, and there's some haymakers being thrown, but that was a series of body blows. The running game got going 4, 5, 6 yards a pop, and then when they needed it, Jared Stidham with some accurate balls down the field in order to convert on third down and keep themselves on the field en route to a TD.
Chris Callahan in the attempt the extra point, and it's good. So let's take a look at the KFC stat comparison.
Baylor already 96 rushing yards. They're going to love seeing that. That was something that they came into the game wanting to correct after the last couple. Getting it done in the passing game as well. 295 yards, 12 first downs.
And you have to consider that Baylor was held to 239 yards and 23 points below its season average last week against Oklahoma.
Now, Oklahoma is a great defense. I will say that. You know, I know most people outside of this conference don't think that anyone in this conference plays great defense. Oklahoma does. And this Baylor offense will attest to that. And that Oklahoma team probably playing as well or better than anybody in the country right now.
Mike Stoops, the defensive coordinator at Oklahoma. It's taken him some time, but he's finally got him turned around defensively. Jeff Carr, the deep man for the Cowboys. And Spencer Evans will send it away. Kicks it to the far side. And Jeff Carr. As he crosses the 30 up to the 32 with his forward progress. All right, let's go to Los Angeles and check in with Jenny Taff for a game break.
Thanks, Gus. Well, you guys, we're just talking about number 7 Oklahoma. They're hosting number 18 TCU. And the Horned Frogs strike first as redshirt freshman Foster Sawyer in for the injured Trevon Boykin finds Colby Listenby. TCU up 7-0 in the first quarter, guys.
How about that? TCU right down the field. Heck of a throw from the youngster.
First down and 10 at the 32. for Mason Rudolph. Carson tries to get outside, bottled up and taken down at the line of scrimmage. Nicely done by Blanchard, the outside linebacker.
This defense playing without a lot of their stalwarts. Orion Stewart, a safety, returning all Big 12 player. Bo Blackshear, a defensive tackle, returning all Big 12 player. Both out for this game. They've held up decently so far.
Second and nine at the 33. Rudolph sets up a screen. He's got his man and some running room. Carson down the sideline and out of bounds at the Baylor 42. Teyon Sells pushes him out of bounds after the 23-yard gain.
They got so aggressive in that rush. You saw those Baylor players right in the face of Mason Rudolph. Great play call right there from Mike Yurchich and Mike Gundy. Dumping it over that rush, getting down the sideline for a big play.
First down to the 42. And Rudolph to throw. In trouble and sacked. Trevon Blanchard got to the quarterback.
No one playing better on this defense than Trevon Blanchard, number 48. Last week had 14 tackles, 13 of them solo stops in the game against Oklahoma. He had three tackles for loss and a sack. So now back-to-back games with a sack for Trevon Blanchard, the nickelback for Baylor.
And it's a loss of 9, second and 19 at the 49. Here's Rudolph to throw it. Underneath, caught. What a catch at the 35. Austin Hayes just laid out and says, give it to me.
And when the timing and accuracy is there, the ball placement is there. I mean, the passing game really is a beautiful thing. And that ball was thrown perfectly on time, allowed Hayes to go after it and get it, left his feet, brought it down for now a much more manageable third down scenario.
J.W. Walsh comes in at quarterback now for Oklahoma State. On third down and 3 at the 35, he generally runs it in these situations. Walsh to throw it this time, up top! And incomplete, and the flag on the play. Aitman, the intended receiver.
And they're going to get this from the offensive perspective. Marcel Aitman shoved the corner right in the back. That's number 9, Ryan Reed. Extended with that right arm. Pretty clearly going to go against Marcel Aitman. Full extension with that right arm. Now they have to make the decision if they want to back him up.
Offensive pass interference. Number 3. 15-yard penalty, still third down.
I would have thought about declining that penalty would have brought up fourth down and forced them into a decision there, either bring out the field goal kicker, but I guess you just hope they don't have a big play here. Art Briles rolling the dice, trying to get them out of field goal range.
So third down and 18 at midfield. Cowboys need to go to the Baylor 32 for a first down. Mason Rudolph back in at quarterback. And here's Rudolph. Winds up down the field. Washington. Incomplete.
Boy, Baylor dodged a bullet there. Ben Grogan, the kicker for Oklahoma State, has not attempted a kick of over 50 yards all season. That attempt, if they would have declined the penalty, would have been 52 yards, likely a punting situation. And with James Washington on the outside, you see that ability. I mean, the throw took him out of bounds. He comes back for that ball. And I thought Baylor dodged a huge bullet there on third down.
So Zach Seiner in to punt for the third time. On fourth down and 18 from his own 35. Links Hawthorne, the deep man. End over end kick. And Hawthorne has it at the Baylor 19. So the Cowboy defense back on the field. They are going to need a stop, led by Emmanuel Akbar.
Here are some guys I'm watching for the race for the Heisman Trophy. with the Nissan Heisman watch. Derrick Henry, Ezekiel Elliott, and Baker Mayfield. And, of course, with Ohio State losing and Zeke not having a great game. And then showing a little attitude afterward. He and Cardale Jones essentially saying that they're going to leave school, go to the NFL, and he was not happy with the play calling. I got news for you, Ezekiel Elliott. Tom Herman is not walking through that door anytime soon.
Corey Coleman, though, trying to get around the corner. He's a Heisman candidate as well. And Coleman taken down at the 24 by Chad Whitner.
You see already the creative play calling from Kendall Briles, trying to get Corey Coleman involved in any way that he can. Now the jet sweep, we've seen him line up as a tailback as well.
Second down and six at the 24. Stidham, pump fake. Stidham in trouble. Stidham looking. And Stidham gets down close to the first down. Jordan Railford coming up with the tackle from behind.
Third down here for this OSU defense. Chance to get off the field.
Third down and one. Here's a handoff. Linwood and a first down.
You know, the tempo from Baylor is used as a weapon in short yardage situations because Kendall Briles says you can steal first downs. You can steal a yard or two almost four or five times a game.
And this is Shock Linwood trying to make something out of nothing as he is stopped by Jordan Stearns and Jordan Burton. There's Kendall Briles, offensive coordinator, the son of head coach Art Briles. And some confusion, it looks like, from Oklahoma State defensively. Flag on the play.
Looked to me like Baylor did some substituting in the...
Illegal substitution. Defense. It's a 5-yard penalty. Second down.
Oklahoma State's upset because they don't feel like they had the opportunity to match up after a substitution. They were trying to run in a whole new package. Glenn Spencer, the defensive coordinator for Oklahoma State. That's what you got to be careful of against this tempo offense of Baylor. You're trying to run guys on the field, in particular wholesale changes like four different defensive linemen. You better make sure that the officials are holding the snap and giving you the opportunity to match up.
Second down and three. And they'll hand it off to Johnny Jefferson. And Johnny Jefferson will get close to the first down. Trace Clark, senior from Wichita, Kansas, with the tackle, third and one. Jefferson again, first down, Baylor.
That's exactly what I was talking about before. Lining up, trying to ensure yourself you're going to get a base look from the defense because you're forcing them to line up so quickly, and then you steal a yard or two and move the chains.
First down. Stidham. Corey Coleman at midfield. And Coleman wrestled down by Kevin Peterson.
Now, one of the things that impressed me so much about Kevin Peterson is a lot of times you see corners that aren't great tacklers in space, but every time you see Peterson get an opportunity, he's a very sure tackler in one-on-one situations.
Second and four at the 49. Flag on the play. Coleman with the catch. But there is a flag at midfield.
Illegal formation, offense, more than 4 men in the backfield. 5-yard penalty, second down.
That's a product of a young quarterback. When you have a veteran quarterback, one of the jobs of that quarterback is to make sure that the formation is correct and the players who are on the line of scrimmage need to be all the way up and on the line of scrimmage.
Second and nine at the 46, and some movement in the backfield again. This time it's Gus Penning.
False start, offense, number 15, 5-yard penalty, still second down.
There's some self-inflicted wounds here. Gus Penning, a senior, junior college transfer from Grand Rapids Community College and Riverside Community College, but those penalties clearly hurting in this set of downs.
Second down and 14. And a bobbled snap. Stidham picks it up and is crushed as he releases it. That's not the kind of hit you want. Agba getting to the quarterback who's got a tender back.
Emmanuel Agba, one of the best players in college football. Relentless effort. Big 12's defensive player of the year a year ago. Splits the double team and gets to the quarterback.
Two sacks at Iowa State last week, leads the Big 12 in third nationally with 11. So a great opportunity for Oklahoma State.
Ruling on the field was an incompleted forward pass. Previous play is now under further review.
Well, as we took a look at the replay, he definitely hit Stidham's right elbow. The question will be, does the ball go straight up or forward? The ball definitely goes forward. That would make you assume that there was at least a little bit of movement from that arm going in that direction.
I don't know, Joel. That looks like a fumble.
I hear you. At the last second, boy, that's awful close. So we were talking with Mike Pereira earlier. Generous of the replay official trying to start. See how that is moving forward.
I don't think it was moving forward, Joel. Was it? Was his arm moving forward?
I thought I saw a little bit of forward movement. I see it's very close. There's no question that it's very close.
Mike Pereira, your thoughts?
I think you're right, Gus. I think it's awful close, and Joel, awful close. You know what awful close means? You don't change it. Ooh. If it's ruled an incomplete pass, to me, the elbow hinges and the hand starts a bit forward with the ball before it comes loose in his hands. I just don't think it's obvious enough to overturn. You get a little forward movement there. Toughest call, by the way, that the referee has to make. But again, I don't see this as indisputable enough to overturn when they're trying to stay with the calls that are made on the field unless it's clearly incorrect.
Mike, if I were to make an argument, here's the argument that I'd make as a quarterback, that the nose of the football doesn't necessarily need to be pointed down the field in order for it to be moving forward. The technique of a quarterback is going to push the front of the ball away, and then that ball will start moving forward even if it's not pointing down the middle of the field. I know it's a close call, but the movement of the ball after it was knocked loose going clearly forward, how much would they look at that, Mike? Where the ball goes after it's knocked loose.
I will tell you, replay officials aren't that smart, Joel, where they can talk about the technique and the points of the ball. They have a hard enough time trying to figure out now, is the ball, remember, in college, it's hand or arm moving forward
after
at all.
After review, the ruling on the field stands.
All right, thank you very much, Mike. 9:28 to go. Baylor will retain possession.
So, I'm such a quarterback homer.
You got to dumb it down sometimes, partner.
You know,
it's... you got to dumb. My aunt is watching. She doesn't understand all that stuff you're talking about.
I'm always looking for excuses for the quarterback. That's
right.
Just the bottom line.
I know.
You know, got to dig deep for those sometimes.
Third down and 14 at the 41. Listen to this crowd. Stidham sets up. Stidham looking, wants to run it. Can he get there? Stidham on the move. First down, Baylor. So the young fella, who was known as a dual threat quarterback in high school, uses his legs.
This is a great decision, and he gets a wonderful block from Shaq Linwood down the field. Took a little bit of a shot in his back there late, but this guy showed some wheels.
A 16-yard gain. Stidham down the field looking. Coleman incomplete. No flag on the play.
This Oklahoma State team now moving towards a clear double team. It's Kevin Peterson low, and then he passes him off late to number 13, Jordan Stearns, the safety. Some contact there late.
10-yard penalty. First down.
And a penalty behind the play. Late there that we didn't actually pick up, a Corey Coleman looking for the flag down the field. Didn't happen.
A holding called on Broxton. First down and 20. Stidham hands it off to Linwood with running room. And shot Linwood taken down by Trey Flowers after a 7-yard gain.
I mean, that is one of the better open field tackles you're going to see. The safety, Trey Flowers, he's only a sophomore, comes up perfectly.
Stidham to throw it over the middle. And caught in traffic. This time it's Jay Lee. Showing courage there to catch that ball when he knew he was going to be hit. Third down and 3 at the 36. Linwood, first down Baylor.
That's a tendency from Baylor. You know, they run the ball more than anybody in the Big 12 on third and 3 or longer. In fact, they run it over 50% of the time. And with the emphatic whistle, I didn't think Linwood was down, but with the emphatic whistle from the umpire, he didn't allow for a clear recovery. So that play will not be reviewed.
Or will it?
Well, they didn't have a clear recovery.
Rolling on the field is the runner was down. Previous play is now under further review.
Now, if they let that play go and there's a clear recovery, there happens to be an Oklahoma State player near, but with the umpire blowing the whistle multiple times, I understand that's a fumble, but he blew the whistle so emphatically and multiple times, pointing at the ground. Look how everyone just stops. Is that a clear recovery after 4 whistles? With Baylor not having a chance to also go full speed after it? Mike Pereira is in Los Angeles. Mike, am I off my rocker?
No, Joel, you're never off your rocker, but you're absolutely right about this. There's no question it's a fumble. Here's the rule. It has to be recovered in the immediate action after the fumble, and that's the whole thing they're going to look at here. Did players stop around the pile? Did number one, who kind of came in after the play, not very hard, by the way, but came in and pick it up, ball really almost rolled dead here. I don't see how you can put that in the immediate action after the fumble since you had players around the pile that stopped.
I mean, this would be an enormous break for Baylor, because if that whistle is not emphatic, then Kevin Peterson is going to be the first one there, but I would have a hard time awarding the football after a series of 3 or 4 whistles from the umpire emphatically pointing at the ground when everyone else stops. Ball clearly loose. And there you hear the whistles.
And of course, Joel, too, the other thing is they're not going to factor in the whistle. I mean, you're right. I mean, you could see him raising his hand one to signal the play is over, pointing the umpire, pointing with his left hand down to the ground, saying that the runner was down. But regardless of his whistle, did you play? Did, you know, was the action dead
after
around
review,
the ball?
There was a fumble. The ball was recovered by Oklahoma State at the 29-yard line. It'll be 1st and 10.
Well, I understand it. It was a fumble. Peterson was clearly the first one to recover it. Oklahoma State.
Official vote for the next Heisman. 8:29 to play here in the second quarter. And this was about a minute ago. Art Briles talking to the referee.
The entire timeout, this was the conversation that was taking place, and he's talking about the umpire who was emphatically pointing at the ground. Myself, Mike Pereira, think that he has a case. The officials felt differently, awarded the ball to Oklahoma State.
So Baylor went 12 plays covering 61 yards, held it for 4 minutes, and ended up with no points. First down and 10 to the 29. And they'll hand it off to Chalmers, running right. Cuts it inside with the room. And he gets about 7 yards on the play.
This Oklahoma State team, they've lived on turnovers. Glenn Spencer, the defensive coordinator, has done a great job in their last 5 games, 11 takeaways. Done just a remarkable job.
Second down. And Rudolph drops it off to Childs. And he'll be lucky to get back to the line of scrimmage as Taylor Young stops him. So Shaq Linwood fumbling the football. Third down and 2 for Oklahoma State. 7:54 to play in the second quarter.
Now late, they'll go to J.W. Walsh as he trots on the field.
Jeff Carr in the backfield.
Still substituting.
J.W. Walsh runs it straight ahead, and he won't get it. So a fourth down coming up. Oklahoma State unable to capitalize off the turnover. Sean Oakman with the tackle. And they'll punt.
Boy, that's what length will do. He was blocked and had to go 3 or 4 yards directly to his right. And he reaches out with that long reach and is able to get Oklahoma State onto the ground.
So Zach Seiner in the punt for the fourth time. Links Hawthorne back deep. Seiner standing at the 22. Delivers. Hawthorne with a fair catch at the 25. 21-14, Baylor. Back to Stillwater right after this. Leading on the road here at Oklahoma State. Bears with the football. First down at their own 25. Johnny Jefferson in at running back with Jared Stidham. And Stidham to the sideline. And it's caught. Katie Cannon going up high.
What a catch. Has to come back and adjust to the ball and is able to get that left foot down. Boy, that was awful close to that sideline.
Looks like he may have been out of bounds, but they play on. Stidham scrambling. Stidham looking. Drops it off. Jake Lee with the catch. And he gets out of bounds inside Oklahoma State territory.
Scrambled out, made a play, and converts another first down. Excellent play from Stidham.
First down and 10. Here's Johnny Jefferson. And he's taken down. And Johnny Jefferson is a player. Art Briles said he plans to get Jefferson into the rushing mix this week. The explosive sophomore had gone back-to-back games without a carry. 7 carries, 28 yards in this one. And this is his 8th carry.
Expect them to go fast here. They've done it on every other third down situation. Not substitute, play fast. Try to steal a yard.
Look at the total yards. Over 400 for Baylor. 3rd and 2. Jefferson. And he dives forward. It will be close. Seth Jacobs chopping him down.
That's just great balance from Johnny Jefferson. Seth Jacobs is in the backfield, and he keeps himself above the ground, and he dives for that first down. Excellent job.
No, actually, it's 4th down and 1, partner, at the 25. Linwood back in the game at running back, and they'll give it to him. Now they pick up the first down. On 4th and 1.
I thought he had extended past that 24-yard line, but Linwood comes in and cleans it up.
First down and 10 of the 22. Stidham looking. Stidham for Coleman. Incomplete. And I don't know, Joel, you tell me. You have to have an amazing intellect to be able to do what this freshman has done.
Well, clearly, to play in the back half of a season in a championship run and to try to execute the entirety of the offense as a true freshman, it helps that he was able to graduate high school early and be in spring ball last year.
2nd down and 10 of the 22. Stidham handing it off. Linwood. Not a lot. And an injured Bear on the field. Vincent Taylor with the tackle. And that is Gus Penning getting up slowly.
Boy, Vincent Taylor has been so good. And now Oklahoma State, another 3rd down opportunity. This defense has been really good in the last 2 series, making a play to get themselves off the field.
3rd down and 9 of the 21. Oklahoma State showing blitz. Stidham runs it. Stidham tries to get outside. No, he won't. Great defense by Jordan Burton, who tracked down the freshman.
They brought the all-out blitz. I thought they would throw it because they had man coverage on the outside. And Stidham trying to get the edge is not able to get there. Burton, just a great job. A junior college transfer from Kilgore College he's been one of the real bright spots of this team. Anytime we bring up Jordan Burton, Glenn Spencer, the defensive coordinator, he just starts beaming. He's a kid that came in 70 tackles now coming into the game.
So fourth and five, and Art Briles is thinking about going for it. Remember, Chris Callahan has already missed a 45-yarder in his only attempt. .3:30 to go, second quarter. Big decision coming up for the Baylor Bears. And by Dr. Pepper in college football, it's a one-of-a-kind tradition. The plot thickens here in Stillwater. Stidham going down hard on that last run. He looks like he's in pain. Remember, he came into this game with a tender back injury he suffered early on in the Oklahoma game last week. His backup is Chris Johnson, a sophomore from Bryan, Texas. In the meantime, Chris Callahan comes in to attempt a 34-yarder. He missed his only attempt from 45 yards away. This time it's good.
You're back, he asks him. And then from there, goes with the field goal unit, and now they're actually working on the right leg of Jared Stidham as he went down awkwardly.
Injured that back on the third play against Oklahoma. And this is Carr running, and he'll get to the 30, close to the 35. Let's check in with Jenny Taft in Los Angeles for a game break.
Thanks, Gus. Number four Notre Dame and Boston College from Fenway Park in the Shamrock Series. DeShone Kizer to Amir Carlisle after a roughing the kicker call. Extended the drive. The Irish up 10-0 as the second quarter winds down. And guys, Notre Dame's playoff hopes have to improve after Ohio State's loss earlier today.
There's no question. There's a lot of teams that their playoff hopes improve, including Michigan State, including Oklahoma, Oklahoma State, and this Baylor team, who will look to move up if they're able to win here in Stillwater.
First down and 10 at the 32. Rudolph. Sideline. Nice ball. Aitman with the catch, and he's pushed out of bounds at the 38. X Howard defensively as Rudolph will get to the line of scrimmage quickly. Second and three. Rudolph again to throw. Under pressure, and he's sacked. Third sack of the night. Avion Edwards shot out of a cannon.
Edwards, the junior from Stephenville, a little bit of a delay blitz right there. He sees the opening and he takes off. Mason Rudolph had nothing down the field, had to eat it, had to take the sack. What a job from Edwards, backing him up here for a third and long.
That's a loss of six. Third down and nine at the 33. Cowboys need to go to their own 42 for a first down. Here's Rudolph, looking, Rudolph, he's got to deliver and incomplete. Andrew Billings had two hands on him.
They're looking to see if there was a receiver in the area. He was throwing it towards Zach Veach, number 86, but it didn't get anywhere near him.
Potential grounding, offense, number two. Penalty enforced in the spot of the foul. Loss of down. Fourth down.
There's Big Oakman coming in there. There's Billings. Now he's in the grasp, and now he's trying to throw it towards Veach. Veach was out there on the right side, number 86, but it didn't get anywhere close to him. Excellent job by the officials there conferring and then going with the flag.
Fourth sack of the evening for Baylor here in the first half. So Sider will punt it inside his own 10. Lynx Hawthorne standing around the 35. And this will be down at the 42. So with 2:15 to play, which is an eternity for this Baylor offense.
That's not even two-minute offense for them. That's just offense. They've got 42 touchdowns on the season that they've scored in under 2 minutes. Last year, they led the country with 41 of those scores. This year already, with 42. Stidham on the night, 12 of 21, 258 yards and a touch, and six rushes. I'm surprised they've gone to the rushes. A couple of those have been scrambles, but they've actually had him in the zone read game. And with that back injured and slowed, I'm surprised they've gone in that direction.
First down, they'll hand it off to Shaq Linwood. And he spins, turns his legs, and gets to the 45. You can't run Stidham anymore.
No, and now in particular, his ankle clearly got rolled up on. He's gone with the spat. He's limping. That right ankle is pretty heavily taped now, and there's not a lot of bounce in his step.
Second and six. Linwood. And a first down. Looks like it. With 1:45 to go. And they'll say he didn't get there.
No, we both got caught on that. And now Linwood limps off the field.
Third down and one. Johnny Jefferson replaces him. They give it to him. First down, Baylor. And more. Jefferson still on the move. As he drives forward and gets to the Cowboy 35 for a 13-yard gain.
This defense has to recognize that Stidham is no longer a threat in the run game. As Linwood gets attended to on the sideline.
And Jefferson again. And he stood up, sent backwards, Emmanuel Ogba. First man to him.
And you just saw the adjustment. Now these players starting to understand Stidham is essentially a statue now. So these handoffs are no longer read plays. They can just collapse on the running back.
Second and nine. This kid's courageous, though. Here's Stidham. With time, strip, loose, Oklahoma State football. Ogba. He stripped it and recovered it. What a player.
He came into this game with 11 sacks. 26 in his career. Was the active leader in the country. And I just said Stidham was a statue, and he was absolutely a statue in the pocket. Ogba comes in, strips at the ball, then dives over Stidham for the recovery. This guy is amazing.
His third forced fumble of the season, his second fumble recovery.
Stidham saw him. He just couldn't move. He couldn't step up in the pocket.
Can Oklahoma State's offense, though, make Baylor pay? First and 10 at the 38. 45 seconds to go. Rudolph down the field for Washington. Incomplete. Well defended, X Howard, the junior from Houston.
Well, that's why he was one of the Big 12's best corners a year ago. Going up against James Washington, and he's able to go right in between the hands, just like we saw Kevin Peterson from Oklahoma State do earlier in the game.
But Rudolph's got a lead on Joel.
He does. That ball was severely underthrown. If you're going to underthrow it, you got to go to the back shoulder.
Second and 10 at the 38. Rudolph again. Sideline. And out of bounds as Glidden makes the catch.
Such an important series as far as momentum goes. Baylor got the opening kick, so Oklahoma State with a chance to put points on the board, go in at halftime, and then get the opening kick of the second half.
Oklahoma State with two timeouts remaining. Third and five of the 43. Rudolph drops it off in the flats. Carson, and he drops it. Chris Carson taking his eyes off the football.
And Rudolph did exactly what he needed to do. Dumped the ball down. He was being conservative. With two timeouts, that's being afforded to him. The ball was just dropped.
And with 26 seconds remaining, Baylor will get it again. As Oklahoma State punts for the sixth time. Zach Sider. This one off the side of his foot. Takes a Cowboy bounce though. And down inside the 20. Now huddle up with college football experts in live web chats all season long. A new guest every week, the Edward Jones College Football Huddle on FoxSports.com. And I would expect, even though Baylor is a fast-paced team,
that they want to get Jared Stidham into the locker room as fast as they can.
That's right. They've got to take stock of whether he can play or not, because on that last possession, not even for the effectiveness of the offense, Gus, but for the health of a young player, you can't have him standing there as a statue with Emmanuel Ogba on the field.
So he'll take a knee. For Baylor, 443 yards of total offense in the first half. Oklahoma State with 188. So we head to halftime with the score. Baylor 24, Oklahoma State 14. Right now, let's send you to Rob Stone in Los Angeles. Welcome back to Stillwater, Oklahoma. Fox College Football presented by K Jewelers. 24-14 Baylor as we prepare to start the second half. Gus Johnson along with Joel Klatt. Interesting first half.
Yeah.
A lot of opportunities for Baylor. They could be up by more.
Yeah, the 10-point lead for Baylor really could have been stretched out. They had four trips into plus territory, Oklahoma State territory, that ended without a point. This was the first one, a turnover on downs. Jared Stidham had to throw it over the head of Corey Coleman, and then it was a missed field goal from Chris Callahan, wide to the left. Then the turnover started. First it was Shaq Linwood, who put the ball on the ground, and replay was awarded to Oklahoma State, and then Jared Stidham, who's battling some injuries right now, a hurt back, his ankle, the right one is heavily taped up, having a hard time moving in the pocket, and Emmanuel Ogba got to him there, was able to get the ball on the ground and recover it. And there you see, points per trip inside the 40, dominated so far by Oklahoma State. So it's been the opportunities that Baylor has created and not taken advantage of that is the story of the game right now.
Stidham coming out on the field at halftime, noticeably limping. So we'll see if Chris Johnson will be warmed up early for Baylor. Carr and Lacey back deep. And Jeff Carr from the goal line. Gets to the 20. And up to the 23-yard line before being stopped. Now let's go downstairs to Molly McGrath.
Gus, you mentioned it. Jared Stidham walking out very gingerly. Art Briles said it's his back, it's his leg. Name another body part. He is banged up. He said that he's questionable. He may try to play him, but we will see Chris Johnson very soon, he said. Training staff were also working on running back Shaq Linwood's left leg going into the half. There was blood on that leg. He is questionable as well.
All right. Thank you very much, Molly. First down and 10 for Oklahoma State at their own 23. And this ball thrown to the far side and incomplete. Mason Rudolph looking for Aitman, but a flag on the play.
We're going to get a hold here on the interior on the slot receiver.
Personal foul, face mask, defense, number 18. 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
Well, that's what he was holding was the face mask there. Chance Waz, the safety, was lined up on the slot receiver. As he took off down the field, it was number 13, David Glidden. And he just grabbed him by the face mask.
So a first down for OK State at the 38. Chris Carson, the pistol back behind Mason Rudolph. And they'll give it to Carson running left. He cuts it back. A little bit of space, stays on his feet. And Carson taken down by Taylor Young. Great pursuit by the Baylor defense.
And with guys banged up in the secondary, this Baylor team had a couple of safeties leave the game against Oklahoma. The front seven had to play great tonight, and they've done that. Minus 11 yards Oklahoma State has rushing so far. This front seven for Baylor has dominated the game.
Second down and 11 at the 37. Carson in motion out of the backfield. Rudolph throws it to him, and it's incomplete. He knew that Trevon Blanchard was bearing down. And this Baylor defense has looked excellent tonight.
They have. They had those couple of series where they got hit with the big play down the field. Washington got in the end zone. But outside of those two series, we've seen great play from Baylor. Shaq Linwood trying to get loose. The running back, will see that left leg, if he's going to be all right. Stidham now dealing with an injury. This game might be in the hands of the Baylor defense right now.
Third down and 11 at the 37. Rudolph over the middle. Incomplete. That one thrown high
intended for James Washington. And Oklahoma State will punt it away.
A dangerous throw. There were four Baylor Bears around James Washington. There was a window, a small window. If the ball was thrown lower, Washington would have had a chance at it. But the coverage was excellent from X Howard.
So Siner will punt from his own 22. Lynx Hawthorne stands at his own 25. High spiraling kick. Hawthorne backing up, and he has it at the 18. So here's the big question. Can Jared Stidham, bad back, tender ankle play? No, doesn't look like he will. Here comes Chris Johnson.
Chris Johnson, big player, 6'5 and 235 pounds. He lost the backup job to Jared Stidham in fall camp. So they moved him to wide receiver because he's so athletic. He played wide receiver for the entirety of the season until Seth Russell against Iowa State got that neck injury. They brought him back to the quarterback room to be the backup quarterback, and now he finds himself on the field with a 10-point lead as a top 10 team in the country without his starting running back, Shaq Linwood.
Johnson has not thrown a pass this season. In 2014, he was 4-for-4 for 28 yards and ran four times for 29 yards. Dual threat quarterback in high school, was rated the number 5 by One Service. And on first down, Johnny Jefferson. Running the football. He's out of Bryan, Texas. And Jared Stidham may be done for the day.
And they're going to have to slow down their tempo as such. Now it becomes a bleed the clock out type of game.
Second down and 8. Johnson to throw it. Goes down the field. Incomplete. Whoa, what a play on defense by Trey Flowers.
Trey Flowers saved the touchdown with this late reach with his right hand, and his head wasn't even turned. This is just complete luck of the draw. He reaches out with his right hand. What an amazing play, knocking that ball away.
Third down and 8 at the 21. Trey Flowers from Converse, Texas. Johnson in to start the second half for Baylor. These fans here in Stillwater smelling blood in the water now with the third string quarterback and a flag.
First charge, timeout.
Actually, Baylor. They call timeout. Johnson rattled. Gaps here.
Well, they've got to start taking advantage of their opportunities. They weren't able to do that. Oklahoma State, 2 takeaways. Baylor, no points allowed off of turnovers, and this Cowboys team, this offense normally so explosive, but they've been slowed down by Baylor when they've been able to create those chances.
Oklahoma State has punted 6 straight possessions, 36 yards in the second quarter. But right now, they're facing the third string quarterback in young Chris Johnson, sophomore, in for Jared Stidham. Third and 8 at the 21, and Johnson wants to run it. And Johnson picks up a first down.
That's a great play call from Kendall Briles, because there's no possibility of a read or a pitch. That is a designed quarterback run. You take all the indecision out of a young quarterback's mind, and you allow him to do what he does best, which is use his physical talents. Great job by Kendall Briles.
That's a gain of 10. First down at the 31. Johnson handing it off to Johnny Jefferson. So if you weren't with us in the first half, here's the story. Jared Stidham came into the game, their starting quarterback, with a bad back. He injured his ankle, went out. Shaq Linwood in the second quarter also goes out with an ankle injury. So the backup quarterback is in. Chris Johnson and Johnny Jefferson, a sophomore from Killeen, getting the bulk of the carries now with Linwood on the bench. Here's Johnson, the throw to the sideline. Nice toss. Caught. Jay Lee gets out of bounds at midfield. That's a 16-yard gain.
This roster has to play their best football around a very inexperienced quarterback. And you saw it there on that route. That was a great route. Pushing out in order to gain space, making it an easy throw for Chris Johnson.
First down at the 49. Johnson looks calm. He hands it off to Jefferson. And Jefferson gets to the 46. Chad Whitener with the tackle.
Anytime that a backup quarterback is in, the most important people on the field become the offensive linemen. Got to protect and open up run lanes.
Second down and seven. Johnson to throw. And it's caught on the far side by Jay Lee, who gets slammed by Jordan Stearns, but it's a completion. A six-yard gain.
And you see the confidence growing just with play to play, the success for Chris Johnson.
Third down and one. Johnson handing it off. Jefferson, and he won't get it. So that's the play the Oklahoma State defense was looking for. Seth Jacobs with the tackle.
This is that point in the field where Art Briles loves to take a chance, leave his offense on the field, and go for it on fourth down. And even with the third stringer, Art Briles remains aggressive. The Texas gunslinger going for it on fourth.
Fourth down and three. Chafin in the game at running back. They give it to him. And he picks up the first the hard way. Devin Chafin, 6 feet, 225 pounds. Out of Burke Burnett, Texas, he's their power back.
And he needed all 225 of those pounds on the fourth down conversion.
So a gain of four on fourth and three. First and 10 at the 38. Opening series of the second half for Baylor.
All 11 players were not set prior to the snap. Number 85, false start. Offense, 5-yard penalty, first down.
That's Jordan Firebacker. Kendall Briles so upset. See, this is when all the other guys, the 10 players around the quarterback, have got to be great and disciplined, because you can't expect a third stringer to do all of the management things that a normal quarterback would do. So if you're one of the 10, get up, get set, and let him think about other things.
So first and 15 at the 43. Chris Johnson has to lead. He hands it off to Chafin. And he runs into the arms of Jarrell Owens.
They'll move fast here. Snap it quickly on second down.
They need 11. Johnson, play fake. Johnson lofting it in the air.
Caught! Jay Lee! Touchdown Baylor! Chris Johnson stepping in like Johnny U. Unflappable!
What a throw! That ball was perfectly thrown. Late safety help from number 13, Jordan Stearns, but that ball was perfectly thrown. Even if he breaks on time, that's gonna be a touchdown. What a play from Chris Johnson. Welcome to Division I football, young man.
His first career drive for a touchdown, extra point is good. Baylor brings in the third stringer. Business as usual. In for Jared Stidham. He leads him on an 11-play, 81-yard drive, eating up 3 minutes and 58 seconds. On the drive, he's 3 of 4 for 61 yards, and he picked up a key first down on a 10-yard run.
And I guess this shouldn't surprise any of us. Think about all the quarterbacks that Art Briles has ever coached. Going back to his days as a position coach at Texas Tech with Cliff Kingsbury, then at Houston with Case Keenum and Kevin Cobb. He comes to Baylor, and he's got RG3 and then Nick Florence. Then he goes to Bryce Petty, wins a couple of Big 12 championships. Seth Russell was playing well. Jared Stidham was playing well. Now it's just Chris Johnson's turn.
Well, you can never doubt a Johnson. I mean, come on.
You want to play?
That's right.
Give him some of that.
I think I got a year left at 48, Joel. I want to play for Art Briles.
Oh, yes, you do. Oh, my goodness.
So let's see how Oklahoma State responds. Their offense really struggling now. They'll return it with Jeff Carr. And Carr over the 20 up to the 24-yard line. The most fearless voice in sports is on FS1, the one and only Colin Cowherd. He's bold, unique, and outspoken. And you can see him on The Herd every weekday at noon Eastern, only on FS1. You know, we're saying a lot of good things about Colin nowadays. I know you're on his show quite a lot.
I go on once a week. You know, he's at his pulpit. I'm down there on the couch, and we have a nice little chat about college football. How about those last few drives? This Baylor defense, boy, they've been good.
First and 10 at the 24. And they'll hand it off. Rennie Childs. And nowhere to go. This Baylor defense, tell you what, all business. As Andrew Billings and Trevon Blanchard combine on the stop.
Phil Bennett has been one of the better defensive coordinators in college football for a long time. He was the defensive coordinator at Kansas State under Bill Snyder when they had some of those teams that reached, you know, the top two in the country in the early 2000s, late 90s. Now he's got a very dominant front seven, and they're dominating here tonight.
Second down and 13 to the 21. Rudolph fires down the field. And Jawan Seals, 41 yards.
Beautifully thrown ball from Mason Rudolph. That's exactly what they needed. Get the game out of the trenches, out of the defensive lineman's hands for Baylor. Throw some passes down the field. Jawan Seals in for James Washington. Down the field, makes a huge catch.
First down at the Baylor 38-yard line. Rudolph again, lofting it up top, and incomplete. Brandon Shepherd, the intended receiver, well defended by the Bears.
Yeah, Ryan Reed, number 9. Gus, you're exactly right. Very well defended. Even though he got turned around at the start, he got right back to the hip of the wide receiver. That's just excellent play. That's technique at its finest. Getting to the hip of the receiver, not letting him get back outside.
Second down and 10. And Rudolph steps up and sacked by Andrew Billings. That's the fifth of the night.
That's why he was the preseason Big 12 Defensive Player of the Year. Andrew Billings lined up right over the center, and this guy combined speed and power like nobody else in college football. Phil Bennett was at Pitt when Aaron Donald was a defensive lineman. And Phil Bennett, the coordinator, says Andrew Billings has the potential to be even better than Aaron Donald because he's stronger, just as quick, but he's stronger at the point of attack, a powerlifting champion in the state of Texas as a high schooler.
Two sacks tonight, third down and 17. Rudolph lobbing it down the field, and it is incomplete. Seals the intended receiver once again. And with 8 minutes and 12 seconds remaining in the third, Oklahoma State really looking for a way to get their offense revving up.
It's tough unless it comes from that big play because those defensive linemen are playing so well up front.
Zach Seiner again punting for him. The 40 is 7th punt of the game. And Hawthorne has it at the 16. 8:04 to go, third quarter. Baylor with the lead. The big question. Instructions from Kendall Briles, his offensive coordinator. And you said that this offense is not as difficult to play in as some other offenses around the country.
Well, it's built on space and simplicity. And remember, Art Briles has always said, I recruit freaks so that he can put them on the outside and then they can win with athleticism. The goal of the quarterback is to just put the ball into safe spots.
Corey Coleman in the backfield. And Corey Coleman running the football.
Corey Coleman, one of those guys that we would say is freakish. All-American, all-Big 12 honoree, a year ago leads the country catching touchdowns and yards per game.
Second down and 8, Coleman again looking for space, and Coleman tackled from behind by Emmanuel Ogba. Tell you what, this Ogba is just such a special talent,
isn't he? I mean, every snap he's playing hard, doesn't take a playoff even in practice. For a guy sitting on a pile of money, this guy never asks out of practice or any drill.
Born in Lagos, Nigeria, 3rd and 5 of the 22. And they'll hand it off again, and a first down. Shock Linwood back into the game. Tender ankle and all. And he keeps the chains moving for Baylor.
Linwood back in there, but behind a very experienced and big offensive line. The game's in their hands. If they can protect Chris Johnson and allow for some running game, Baylor's in a great spot.
First down and 10. And another handoff, Linwood. This time he goes backwards And it's Seth Jacobs getting in to the backfield.
What's going to happen? All night long, they've been trying to double-team Corey Coleman on the outside. But now, Glenn Spencer and Mike Gundy are going to have to commit more of their resources to stopping the run, which is going to create one-on-ones on the outside.
Second down and 12 at the 29. Johnson to throw it. Johnson winds up down the field again.
Chris Johnson.
That was an amazing throw, but that play was set up by a beautiful route from KD Cannon. Watch him give the safety a double move. He's going to come inside right there and then boop, gives him a head bob, and now he's gone. The sprint champion running right by the safety. A beautiful throw from Chris Johnson, and it's another touchdown for the explosive Baylor Bears.
37-14 Baylor with 6:24 to go in the third quarter. The Bears with 607 yards in total offense. Cannon, 5 catches, 210 yards and 2 touchdowns. What a throw from the third stringer.
Sometimes
it's real simple.
And sometimes it's simple, man. That's the truth.
Dude, when you got speed like that, Chris Johnson, boy, doesn't this feel a lot like Cardell Jones in that Big Ten championship game?
Well, I was there. I was there at that game. Doesn't feel like that, Joel, because that was for a championship.
I hear you. I hear you.
And that young man went on to win the national championship, has still never lost a game, got benched, and he's never lost.
I mean, tell me how you feel about
it. Oh, my goodness. I can't believe that. Never lost a game, got benched. 2 games later, they lose.
Chris Johnson trying to do his best impression. This Baylor team, they're alive for their third straight Big 12 title, and they are alive for a playoff spot. College football, as it is each and every year this time of year, gets crazy.
Juwan Seals, Jeff Carr back deep for Oklahoma State. And they'll start from the 10-yard line with Jeff Carr. And Jeff Carr crosses 25 up to around the 28 before being stopped. Baylor, 24 straight points, 7 straight Oklahoma State punts. Baylor, 16 completions for 390 yards.
We added in the dead ball spot. First down.
Averaging 24.4 yards per completion. Johnson perfect, 4 of 5, 132 yards and 2 touchdowns. KD Cannon, 5 catches, 210 yards and 2 touchdowns.
And Gus, that might be overshadowing maybe the best performance of the night, the front seven of this defense.
That's right, they have been
negative 21 brilliant yards rushing for Oklahoma State. They have been unbelievable. Only 218 yards total for this Cowboys offense.
Oklahoma State came into this game averaging 145 yards rushing per game. 5 sacks also for Baylor. First and 10. And it's caught on the far side by Marcel Aitman. But what have they done? How have they been able to slow down this Oklahoma State offense?
It's been personnel driven. It's not the scheme. It's been the fact that Andrew Billings is winning. And you've got guys like Sean Oakman that's winning. Jamal Palmer up front. They're just beating their opponent.
Rudolph, near side. And it's caught. Washington, and he'll get to midfield. Ryan Reed stopping him as well as Chance was.
And they were supposed to be depleted, but you've got guys like Billings and Oakman that are playing a three-man front and still not allowing Oklahoma State to run the football. So that's why you're having to see right now, and the score, obviously, 38-14. But Oklahoma State is going to have to abandon this run game and try to just put the ball up in the air to come back.
First down and 10 at midfield. Rudolph to throw it again. And Rudolph to Washington. And he's unable to hold on to the ball. And that's because X Howard there defensively for the Bears.
Boy, Howard had a tremendous night tonight. He was beat once earlier in the game by James Washington. But for the most part, he has been right there in his hip pocket, ready to pounce on each and every completion.
Second down and 10.
over the middle. And it's complete for a first down. Glidden finding a soft spot.
Glidden had been so quiet tonight. He was their leading receiver coming into the game with over 700 yards and 45 catches. Mason Rudolph's been unable to find him for the majority of the game.
First down at the 36. Rudolph goes up top and incomplete. Aitman, the intended receiver for Baylor, but Teon Wright was there, the junior from Amarillo.
Watch this coverage. Gus, this is as good as you can play it. Watch the corner. He cuts him off. That's exactly what he's coached to do. Beat the wide receiver to the spot. Run the route for him. And the timing was all thrown off. Ryan Reed, that's just sensational coverage.
Second and 10.
Carlton Buckles, the corners coach, has got to be thrilled with the way his guys have played tonight.
Here's Rudolph. Nice throw. Aitman grabs it, gets out of bounds in front of X Howard.
And this offensive line has been able to provide a little time on this series and allowed Mason Rudolph to get the ball down the field. And they've been coupling together some first downs for the first time in a couple of quarters.
First down at the 22 of Baylor for Oklahoma State. Rudolph, quick throw this time in the corner. Caught, no, incomplete. Seals the intended receiver. Just couldn't hold on.
Ryan Reed again with the coverage. And again, you see a defensive back's hand right between the arms of a wide receiver. He was slow to get up there in the corner. I think they're going to have to actually come and attend to him there. Ryan Reed, the junior from Sherman, Texas, has three interceptions on the year. He did not get a chance to play spring ball last year because he had a surgery to repair a core muscle injury that was injured. Really versatile prep athlete. This is the prototypical guy that Art Briles loves to recruit. He played defensive back, wildcat QB, receiver, returner. He was a place kicker for his high school team.
And you love to talk to Art Briles with that great Texas accent. I don't recruit just athletes, I recruit freaks. And that's what I want on this team. If you can't run, you can't play for me. Because I can teach a fast guy how to catch, but I can't teach a slow guy how to run.
That was perfect. I can tell you spent some time in Waco.
That's right. Second down and 10 of the 22. Home away from home. And the delayed handoff to Carson with space. Carson cuts it back inside and will be close to a first down.
Really good call there from Mike Yurchich, the offensive coordinator, with only three down defensive linemen and everyone dropping into coverage. That delay or the draw play is an excellent call because you allow them to get down the field, hand it off, find the space to run.
Well, J.W. Walsh in the game on third down and one. Here's Walsh running it for the first down. He has it. Oklahoma State hasn't scored since 6:40 remained in the first quarter. They're close now as Mason Rudolph comes back in.
Well, we've seen him come back from 17 down. Now a deficit of 20. Shoot, what is that, 24? My math is all screwed up, Gus. This game's got me all excited.
Econ major, first down and goal at the 9. And Rudolph in the end zone. Incomplete. Seals the intended receiver. And that one knocked away by X Howard again.
Howard almost ran that route perfectly, turning Seals into the defender.
Coleman going out, heading into the locker room.
Boy, this Baylor team so depleted.
Second down goal of the 9. Glidden in motion. Rudolph looking in the corner. He's got a man. Touchdown. Jalen McCleskey.
What a route, what a throw. And an excellent drive from Oklahoma State. That's exactly what they needed. He's the inside receiver, and he's going to run a corner route. And that ball is thrown right when he breaks out. Perfectly thrown. Good air on it right in the sideline. The true freshman, McCleskey, with his second touchdown of the night.
Ben Grogan in to attempt the extra point. And it's good. 3:19 to go third quarter. Oklahoma State showing some signs of life, but they've got a lot of work to do. Can they figure a way to rattle? He's at 10-0. 7-0 in the Big 12. But right now, Art Briles has his team playing like a bunch of porch dogs.
Yes, they do. He said earlier this week, he doesn't want a team that's going to sit there and have to warm up. You ever seen a porch dog warm up before he takes off after a car? He's gone.
This one kicked out of bounds.
Free kick out of bounds. Kicking team. Ball placed at the 35-yard line. First down.
All right, let's go to Jenny Taft in Los Angeles for a game break.
Thanks, Gus. Here's an update from number 4 Notre Dame in Boston College. The Irish have turned it over 5 times already, but finally put this together as Deshaun Kizer finds Chris Brown 12 yards for the touchdown as Notre Dame leads 16-3 in the fourth quarter. Gus Joel.
All right, thank you very much, Jenny. Now, if Notre Dame wins that game, they have a huge matchup next week in Palo Alto with Stanford.
And it'll be their last game of the season, and it will be, at least for them, they would be hoping an exclamation point for the committee as their last game to try to get into the second ever college football playoff.
First down and 10 at the 35 for Baylor. Chris Johnson in at quarterback for Stidham. Johnson running it straight ahead. Johnson, beautiful move as he gets to the 50. A 14-yard gain. Jordan Stearns brings him down.
Boy, this guy has just been amazing. Throwing the football, making good decisions in the run game. And now I love what the coaching staff is doing because they're controlling the clock for him. Having them huddle up. Now they bring him over to the sidelines. The only thing that Kendall Briles has to be worried about is you don't want to put him up against the play clock. Try to get him to the line of scrimmage at about 10 so that then he can snap the football at around 5.
Corey Coleman back in the game. He's the receiver at the bottom of your screen. And the handoff goes to Chafin. And this time the Oklahoma State defense is there. As Mile and Clark combine on the tackle.
Mile, another one of these junior college transfers from Tyler Junior College, has played very well for Glenn Spencer's defense.
Second and 11. Johnson to throw. Now Johnson scrambles, and he'll go out of bounds. And that'll bring up third down and long.
Good decision, though, for Chris Johnson. He wanted to go to Jay Lee, number 4, on the far side on a curl route. It was excellent coverage, and so rather than force the ball, he runs it out of bounds, lives to play another down.
Well, this is a big one for Oklahoma State. They got to get off the field. Third down and 11. Johnson has had the answers.
Expect some pressure from Oklahoma State.
Here they come. Johnson throws it near side and incomplete. Corey Coleman, the intended receiver. And now Oklahoma State will get it back. As Drew Galitz comes into the game to punt for the first time for the Bears.
That's just an excellent stop from Oklahoma State. Giving their offense a chance. Still in the third quarter. This team has seen deficits before and they've overcome them for wins.
Jalen McCleskey standing at his own 10. As Drew Galitz will punt it away from the 34. And McCleskey lets it take a bounce. And it's a Baylor bounce. Downed all the way inside the 5 at the 1-inch line. Great job by Drew Galitz. So Oklahoma State, they've been down before. Down 15 points to K-State. They came back to win it by 2 against Texas Tech. Cowboys trailed by 17 points in the first quarter, pulled out a win. Last week, they trailed Iowa State by 10 points in the fourth quarter, went on to win it. Different story here, different caliber of a team. Baylor with a 38-21 lead, a minute 44 to go in the third quarter.
This drive, Gus, is so important. A touchdown on this drive essentially recreates the same situation they were in last week on the road, down 10 in the fourth quarter. Huge to get points here. They would have very strong belief in themselves if they could create that scenario.
But they'll start from their own one. Rudolph to throw underneath, caught, nicely done. Glidden, he gains 9.
That's huge. Whenever you're backed up inside the 5, your goal as an offense is to get 2 first downs in order to reestablish field position. They're able to get at least close to one of those on the first play.
Second and 1. And they'll hand it off to Carson, who picks up a first down as he gets to the 15.
Starting to see that tempo back, the momentum back with this offense.
First down at the 15-yard line. Rudolph, pump fake, looking. And that one caught by Glidden. And he dives forward to the 20. What a tough catch by David Glidden.
Blanchard was the one that was right there. Glidden's going to have to lead the game because Trevon Blanchard at 6'2", 205, he was there almost simultaneously with the ball.
Glidden, Oklahoma State's offensive MVP in 2014. After catching 42 balls, he leads him in receiving this year. Second and 5. Taylor on the draw play. First down.
That draw play, such a good call right now. Baylor is dropping everybody in coverage and allowing just their front three to defend the run. You allow those linebackers to get depth, hand off the late ball, create some space, and he runs for a first down.
At the 28, Rudolph down the field, and incomplete. That ball intended for McCleskey, and he got driven down hard by Chance Waz.
Boy, Waz was like shot out of a rocket coming from distance, and he's going to go right after the wide receiver, and he gets him right in the chest. Crowd here wants a targeting penalty. I'm glad the flag didn't come out because that contact was right in the chest.
Second and 10 at the 28. Rudolph down the field again. He's got a receiver. Incomplete. Washington. He had a step on Ryan Reed.
There was just a little bit of hand fighting, and then that ball right in the hands of James Washington. He's got to come up with that one for his quarterback. Mason Rudolph with a terrific throw down the field. Player the caliber of James Washington normally comes down with that.
Well, that makes it third down and 10 at the 28. Could be the final play of the third quarter. Rudolph over the middle. And incomplete. Glidden, the closest man to the football. Rudolph under pressure.
He's going to have him wide open. Watch this. The safety bites. If he throws this ball down the field, that's going to end up in the end zone. He thought he was breaking across a read route in the middle, and Rudolph knows it. If he just throws that ball as far as he can, Glidden's in the end zone right now.
Siner will punt it away from the 13. Hawthorne back deep. Beautiful spiraling punt. Hawthorne with it at the 27. And he's taken down to the 29. And that's the end of the third quarter. A lot of big plays in this game. Chris Johnson leading. Baylor up 38-21. Ready to start the fourth quarter here in Stillwater, Oklahoma. Baylor with the lead as you take a look at the scoring by quarters.
Boy, that 14-point third quarter was all Chris Johnson. I mean, this guy, if he can keep this up, he's going to reach legend status in one half of football.
First down and 10 of the 29. Johnson to throw it on first down. In trouble, decides to run it. And Johnson gets up to the 34-yard line, maybe the 35, as Agba tracked him down. And the story here, Jared Stidham started the game, came in with an injured back, hurt his ankle at the end of the first half. Chris Johnson started the third quarter, and he's led him on two big drives for touchdown. Second and four. Johnson, long again, deep and incomplete. Coleman had it. Kevin Peterson covering.
Boy, you just don't see Corey Coleman drop the football like that. Normally, this guy is so aggressive at the catch point. It's like he's fighting for the ball at all times. Plays with a rare attitude on the football field. Very rare to see him drop a ball like that.
Third down and four at the 35. Wouldn't be surprised to see Johnson drop back and take off. He'll hand it off. And it's Chafin for the first down and even more.
That's what's so unique about Baylor. They're the only team in the Big 12 that runs the ball over 50% of the time on third and medium downs. That means third and 3-7 to go. Glenn Spencer talked about it to us yesterday. He said it was such an odd down and distance to try to call defense because normally every other team in the Big 12 is heavy pass percentage in that down and distance. Baylor, they'll be patient enough to run it. Very difficult to defend.
Baylor 11 of 18 on third down conversions. Chafin remains in the game. First down at the 44. They give it to him straight ahead and he'll plow forward. Gains five.
This offensive line doing a heck of a job opening up holes. Devin Chafin has come in. He's been pretty productive on the few carries that he's gotten. 6 foot, 225 pounds, junior from the state of Texas. Guy is so powerful. He's taking the place of starter Shaq Linwood, who's been banged up. That left leg has a wrap on it. He's been banged up. Chafin is a guy very powerful in his lower body. He can squat 570 pounds as a running back. That's an amazing amount.
Six carries, 21 yards, second and five. Chafin again. And that'll bring up third down and short as Chad Whitner makes the tackle.
I'd go right back to Chafin. He's fallen forward every single time he's been contacted by the defense. The offensive line has done a heck of a job. He's probably his number 28.
Chafin running, looking for the first, and he has it.
It's so important. It's such a little thing for a running back, but a running back that falls forward, that gains that extra yard or two on every carry, you start adding it up on the end of a night. 20 carries, you get two, three extra yards. You're talking about 20, 40, 50 extra yards, those first down yardage. So critical, and he seems to have that characteristic.
First down at 10 at the 45 for Baylor. Here's Johnson in trouble, throws, and incomplete. Johnson under pressure, but he uses that frame. He's a big guy, 6'5", 235.
I've been impressed with how patient he's been in the passing game. He's only taken the shot when it's there, when he's got an open receiver. If he doesn't like it, if it looks dirty, a lot of quarterback coaches say, hey, if you look out there and it's dirty and it's messy, you got to pull that ball down and use your feet. Johnson did that. There was nowhere to run, so he threw the ball away. It's a very mature decision from a guy that's really playing his first meaningful half of football in college.
Second down and 10 at the 45. And a handoff to Chafin. Tries to get outside and cross forward and gets to the 40. As he picks up 5 yards.
Check out big Jarrell Broxton on the pull. I mean, he is out there, and he gets a devastating block on the edge. Bang, right there. He opens up the hole. Chafin bounces outside, gains positive yardage.
Third down and five at the 40-yard line. This time, Chafin will be tackled for a loss. So a big decision coming up for Art Briles. It's going to be fourth down. Seth Jacobs with the tackle. So Briles thinking about it. His offense still on the field.
Boy, in a normal situation, this is a go-for-it moment for Art Briles, but with his third-string quarterback in and his defense playing so well, and particularly against the run, getting to the quarterback.
So they're going to punt it. As they said, Galen's in. McCleskey back deep at his own 10.
Delay of game, offense, 5-yard penalty, fourth down.
It's actually going to help him, back him up 5 yards, try to pin him inside the five. Remember, on his only other punt of the night, Gus, Galitz pinned him inside the one.
It's a 50-yard punt.
He's trying to do that same thing here, playing the field position game.
Galitz has a strong leg. He gained notoriety as a prep kicker when he booted a 71-yard field goal at a kicking camp in 2014. Pops this one high in the air. And it's fair caught at the 20. So Mason Rudolph and the Oklahoma State offense with the deficit, but they've got the ball. They must make something happen quickly. Buy Fallout 4, the next generation of open world gaming, available now. So here we go, Baylor up 38-21, Oklahoma State, their undefeated season on the line now. As they start at their own 21. James Washington, the electric wide receiver, has to make his presence felt for the rest of this game. Rudolph sets up a screen. He's got Carson with blockers in front of him. And he finally goes down at the 31. First down, Oklahoma State.
For the same reason a draw is a great run call, the screen is a great pass call, in particular on first down. Let that rush get up the field, drop it over their head. We've seen it work a couple of times now for Oklahoma State.
From the 32. And Rudolph with the play fake. Fires down the field. And incomplete. This time intended for Juwan Seals, covered by X Howard, who's been terrific tonight.
X Howard was a defensive back and quarterback in high school at Wheatley High School in Houston. He's obviously on the track team, which most guys from Baylor were on the track team, played basketball as well. Very athletic, and you're seeing that come to fruition here tonight.
Second down and 10 to the 32. Rudolph over the middle, high and incomplete. Washington, the intended receiver, he was open.
These linebackers are dropping back into coverage so quickly. Watch number 20. Drops back right in the middle of things. He's able to be right there, and that is going to force the ball to be way too high. He's throwing the ball high. Avion Edwards drops into that spot. Mason Rudolph can't drop it in over his head.
Third down and 10 at the 32. Mason Rudolph in trouble. Underneath and incomplete. James Washington, closest man to the ball. And Oklahoma State will have to punt.
And it was Jamal Palmer with the pressure. He's going to come around on the right side of the offense. Jamal Palmer is a senior from McKinney, Texas. He almost batted that ball right out of Mason Rudolph's hand. And because he was off balance and had to get rid of the ball with the rush bearing down on him, had nothing on it and couldn't get it to Washington over the middle of the field.
So Siner will punt for the 10th time tonight. Hawthorne back deep. And Hawthorne has it at the 25. 10-16 to play in the fourth. Here comes Chris Johnson. He's got a 38-21 lead.
The Bears, an excellent first half. Got this 10-point lead, but at the end of the half, start getting banged up. Stidham left the game with a leg injury, as well as Shock Linwood. And the new sheriff came to town. His name, Chris Johnson. Couple of huge touchdown passes gave Baylor this lead. Johnson 4 of 8 for 132 yards and two touchdowns after Stidham played well and courageous, battling that back injury and then an ankle injury late in the half.
On first down, Chafin running, trying to get outside, and Dunn stays on his feet, powers his way for first down. But just think how different this game would be without Johnson's heroics. We'd probably have a three-point game.
Yeah, they became more dynamic in the run game with Johnson on the field. And what that did, Gus, was it created one-on-one matchups on the outside. As soon as Baylor gets one-on-one matchups, what do? Attack them down the field. And that's when the big plays occurred for the touchdowns down the field with Chris Johnson. So it was really, I hate saying this, it was almost a blessing in disguise that Johnson came on the field and started running the ball effectively.
First down and 10 at the 37. And Johnson completing it to Corey Coleman. And let's get a quick game break from Jenny Taft in Los Angeles.
Thanks, Gus. Here's an update from Norman, Oklahoma, without quarterback Baker Mayfield out for the rest of the game with an injury. But no worries. Samaje Perine takes over, 72-yard run for the score. And the Sooners lead 30-13 in the third quarter. Guys?
Wow. I just, you know what strikes me immediately when I hear that? These top four teams in the Big 12, three of them playing with backup quarterbacks right now. In this day and age, a quarterback's being exposed in the run game, you just can't expect them to play the entire season.
Remember, this Baylor team is at TCU next week, and they'll wrap up the regular season against Texas at home. Oklahoma State, their final game of the year will be Oklahoma right here on the 28th.
Seth Russell over there in that neck brace. All of us wishing him well on his recovery after suffering that neck injury. Jarrett Stidham leaving in this ball game, and now it's all about Chris Johnson.
Third down and two. Johnson handing it off. Chafin makes the first man miss and picks up the first down.
Oof. Did you see that move?
What a move.
When running backs can make people miss in the backfield, what they're doing is they're being their own blocker. They're erasing mistakes up front with their own ability. He makes two Cowboy defenders miss, dives forward for a first down. What an excellent run from Devin Chafin. They've needed some production in the run game. He's come in this second half, in particular in this fourth quarter, and just played terrific.
Chafin, 13 carries, 50 yards and a touchdown. First down and 10 at the 50. And Johnson throws it softly over the middle, and it's caught for another big game. Firebarker, but a flag on the play.
They're going to have Spencer Drango, the offensive lineman, down the field. He tried to hide himself and go down and lay down so the referee wouldn't see him, but he wasn't buying it. He was running right with Jordan Firebarker.
There were fouls by both teams. Ineligible receiver downfield, number 58, offense. Personal foul, face mask, defense. Those penalties will offset. We'll replay first down.
All right, so first, here's Spencer Drango from the left tackle position. You see him blocking all the way downfield. I mean, this is him. He's right next to the wide receiver that's down the field. But then the personal face mask at the end. Bauerbacher dragged down by his face mask. Get the offsetting. Baylor bailed out a little bit there with that late face mask from the Cowboys. I just love that Drango went down like he was trying to hide. He's 320 pounds.
He can't hide.
You're not hiding from anybody, big guy.
Drango, such a talented player for this Baylor football team. First down at midfield. Johnson, pump fake. Under pressure. Dances out of the pocket. And throws down the field. Intercepted. That's a big-time interception for Oklahoma State. Jordan Stearns gets it to midfield with 7:10 to go. Baylor's turned it over three times.
There's the mistake. Chris Johnson showing his youth.
Oklahoma State has the football at the Baylor 48-yard line. Time not on their side. 7:10 to go.
three-possession game. You got to be thinking about scoring before the clock hits 5 minutes in order to give yourself a realistic chance.
Rudolph looking. Throws it out wide. It's caught, but not for much. Zach Veach with the reception. Grant Campbell tackling him.
Grant Campbell was like a blanket on him from his middle linebacker spot. Man coverage being played, allowing those down three linemen to try to get a rush on Mason Rudolph.
Here's Rudolph under pressure. Looking and sacked for the sixth time. This time it's Jamal Palmer. This Baylor defense has been extraordinary tonight.
So experienced Jamal Palmer is. Played in 35 career games. Has 3.5 sacks this year. Has already had two here late in this ball game. The last series we saw Jamal Palmer get in there, make a huge play, making his presence known in this ball game.
Third and 16. And Rudolph. Still waiting. Rudolph finally slides down at midfield. Nobody open. Sean Oakman with pressure for Baylor.
And Rudolph clearly hobbled, unable to take off down the field. And it looks like his right ankle is also heavily taped up with some black tape. But as he broke the pocket, we'd normally see him take off. And he just limped to the 50 and slid down.
Oklahoma State going for it on fourth down and 12. Rudolph over the middle. And caught! Glidden! David Glidden with a 36-yard gain on fourth and 12.
Well, when you need a play, it's about David Glidden. And the key here is time, so he can set up that route where he fakes to the outside and comes back over the middle.
First and 10 at the 14. Rudolph over the middle and incomplete. Glidden, the intended receiver, he gets up slowly.
That right hip hit by the safety. Tayon Sells, the junior, the backup safety, having to play tonight. He's played very well. Only played 15 games in his first couple of seasons, but does have an interception to his credit.
Second down and 10 at the 14. And a false start coming up against the Cowboys.
False start. Offense, number 28. 5-yard penalty. Second down.
James Washington, wide receiver, is on the far side of the field. A little too early of a start. They've still got this shot. That 5 minutes and 13 seconds left. They've got to start thinking about taking some shots to the end zone here. The longer this clock dwindles down in a three-possession game, narrower the chances are for Oklahoma State.
Second and 15. Rudolph throws in the end zone, looking for Shepard. And broken up. X Howard again.
He got turned around, but had the makeup speed. Remember, a high school track athlete. He gets turned around, then makes it up and comes back, turns to the ball, and then makes an excellent play on the ball. This guy has just put on a clinic of how to play cornerback so far tonight. X Howard, player of the game for Baylor.
Third down and 15 at the 19. And Rudolph. Flag on the play. Underneath. And it's caught. Touchdown if it stands. James Washington. But let's see.
Offside. Defense. Number 56. Lined up in the neutral zone. That penalty's declined. Result of the play, touchdown.
That's Washington's second touchdown tonight. 5 minutes to go, 38-27.
It's exactly what I said they needed to do. Take a shot to the end zone, score by 5 minutes, and now they've got themselves a chance here in a two-possession ball game with a PAT to come.
Ben Grogan. Ten-point game.
James Washington. Important touchdown. Oklahoma State's not done yet. Nation undefeated. And they still have live James Washington with the touchdown, his second of the night, as you take a look at the drive. So what's the philosophy for Oklahoma State from this point on?
The key is the first down call. You know Baylor has to run the ball. One, they're not going to want to throw it to stop the clock. Two, they don't want to throw it with Chris Johnson, who just made a mistake. I think you kick the ball off deep. You stack the line on first down.
Are you sure, Joel? Looks like he's going to onside it. And he does. Takes a bounce. Corey Coleman scoops it up.
I never like going to the desperation play until I have to. Mm-hmm. Forced into it. This defense was playing well. The offense was on the ropes. Now the defense's job is to hold them to a field goal opportunity. It would still be a two-possession game at that point.
So I totally agree with you. Maybe a tactical mistake by Oklahoma State with 5 minutes to go and the onside kick, especially when you consider Chris Johnson had thrown an interception on their last series. And in all likelihood, they were going to run the ball and punt it away.
They had to run it, you know, because of Johnson being a bit rattled and the clock situation. But now they're still going to be in that run it mode. Look at all those defenders at the line of scrimmage. Man coverage on the outside.
And here's Johnny Jefferson running on first down. He's taken down to 25. And except Jacobs with the tackle.
Mike Gundy doesn't have to start using his timeouts just yet. He'll have to start using them if Baylor gets this first down. He's got three of them left. Gus, you just get the sense, the nature of Baylor with that man coverage, that Kendall Briles is itching to try to take a shot with Corey Coleman. You just get the sense that you might see a fake and Coleman in a one-on-one situation.
Coleman's at the top of your screen. Jay Lee the bottom. And Jefferson. So third down and short coming up for the Bears.
And Mike Gundy is going to use one of his timeouts here. Prepare his defense for a crucial time.
We'll take a break. 4:07 to go. Back after this. Seven to go in the fourth quarter. Baylor faced with a third down and one at the 21.
Gus, I wouldn't fake the ball. I would bring in all the heavy personnel. I would snap it to Chris Johnson, who is 6'5", 235 pounds, and this would be a quarterback run the entire way. Quarterback power from Baylor.
Also, Laquan McGowan, number 80. He's 410 pounds. Trevor Clemens, 98 in. Here's the handoff. Chafin, whoa, he just lowered his shoulder and picked up the first down. Ashton Lampkin threw himself under the chariot.
Boy, Chafin, just some power here. He's going to have a free Oklahoma State defender right in the hole right here. And he meets him, powers through, and is able to get the first down. Always falling forward. Devin Chafin, the junior. 6 foot, 225 pounds with 53 yards rushing on the night.
Shaq Linwood injured his leg. Hasn't seen much action here in the second half. First down and 10 of the 19. And Johnson! Chris Johnson with an 8-yard run. Lampkin with the tackle.
Boy, this guy's got some athleticism, and now Mike Gundy's going to be forced into using his timeouts after this next snap.
And you never want to second-guess a coach like Mike Gundy. He's just one of the best in America, but the onside kick with 5 minutes to go, you wonder if he'd like to have that back.
Well, he would have been in this type of series anyways if he kicked it off, where the defense has to get a stop.
Second down. Chafin, first down.
And if Baylor is able to methodically run the ball, I guess it would be a moot point anyways. But I hear you. I don't like those desperation plays. I don't like going for two until you have to, or the onside kick until you have to. But Mike Gundy, he knows his team better than anybody. He's done a remarkable job. This team, kind of an island of cast-offs. They've got seven different players that were either walk-ons or transfers contributing in a large way. Starters, seven of the 22 starters on his team. Done a remarkable job with this team getting to this point in the season as an undefeated.
First and goal to the 8-yard line. Chafin. And he'll get inside the five. And the thing about Mike Gundy, he's a young man, 48 years old. A lot of job openings this year. South Carolina, only loss of the season last week at home to Oklahoma. This would be a huge road win for Baylor. Mike Gundy, 2:15 away from his undefeated season coming to an end. Second and goal of the four. Johnson, touchdown. He's thrown for two touchdowns. He now has run for a touchdown. Chris Johnson came into this game in the third quarter for Jared Stidham, and he has had the game of his life against the sixth-ranked team in the nation.
There's no more pressure-packed situations than top-10 matchups late in November. And the third stringer, who played wide receiver for the entire season, lost that backup job in fall camp, plays wide receiver all year. When Seth Russell goes down, they bring him back as a quarterback. And Gus, he has played like a champion tonight on the road.
And it's the determination and the will of the Baylor Bears. 2:10 to go, and here's a Dr. Pepper one-of-a-kind play of the game.
Well, you just never know when a backup comes in the game, how is he going to react? Well, how about throwing the ball absolutely perfectly for a touchdown, his first touchdown of the night. The one-of-a-kind play of the game, Chris Johnson. That's an amazing feeling. Gus, get your first action as a quarterback and to play well like that. 5 of 10, 138 yards, two touchdowns. The one interception, which was a mistake, but then makes up for it with a great rushing touchdown here to seal the victory. And the Baylor Bears are alive and well in this crazy ending of a college football season.
Baylor, 707 yards in total offense. Spencer Evans will send it away. Carr and Lacy back deep. Oklahoma State starts inside their own 10 with Jeff Carr. And Carr gets up to the 35. So next week, for us here at Fox, we will travel to Palo Alto. Joel and I will call the Notre Dame-Stanford game, along with Molly McGrath. Huge playoff implications, especially for the Irish.
Oof. That's going to be an amazing game. Notre Dame winning tonight in Fenway Park by 3, 19-16 over Boston College.
Rudolph near side caught out of bounds. That's Shepard.
In a minute 58, the Baylor Bears, Art Briles, and this entire fan base from Baylor is going to become the biggest Oklahoma State fans in the Big 12, with Bedlam looming next week.
Rudolph down the field. And Clark at the 10. Seals out of bounds. Juwan Seals beat his man. And with a minute and 49 to go, he gains 49 yards. And the football will be placed at the 5-yard line.
Shouldn't have spoke too soon. We've seen crazier endings in college football this year. An excellent pass from Mason Rudolph down the sideline.
Here's Rudolph lobbing it. And incomplete. Washington, the intended receiver. Chad Swaz covering him.
this Oklahoma State team, Mike Gundy has said that they just try to scratch and claw, smoke and mirrors their way to 150 yards rushing. They weren't able to do that tonight. This is one of the first games that they haven't been able to do that. J.W. Walsh has not been effective when they brought him in the game. He is going to come in the game here in this goal line situation, however.
Second down and goal at the five. Walsh running it to the right side. And it'll go down at the two. Jamal Palmer with the stop. Clock still running at 1:35 and counting.
We've seen this Baylor team three different times during the course of the season. This is the best the defense has played, in particular that front seven. They played a lot of snaps tonight, but they've been excellent against the run.
Third down goal of the 2-yard line. Walsh again, straight ahead this time. And he'll get in for the score. Game number
one. 45-34. Well, here you go. PAT to make it a 10-point game, and then we're back to that onside kick situation, Gus.
Ben Grogan. And the extra point is good. 10-point game, 1:12 to go. Oklahoma State with one timeout left. Cowboys and the Bears prepare for an onside kick.
Tried to cross them up last time. They came to the wide side of the field. They kicked it right at Corey Coleman. He again will be down here just below the 50 on the bottom of your screen.
This time they kick it to the other side and it goes out of bounds.
Free kick out of bounds. Kicking team. 5-yard penalty from the dead ball spot. First down.
So Art Briles, he's smiling now as his team comes into Stillwater. As you take a look at the remaining games for Baylor, TCU in Fort Worth next week.
Boy, we thought that was going to be just a barn burner of a game. Obviously, still holds so much importance. But this was a gutsy win, just an awfully gutsy win. Down to your third string quarterback, Chris Johnson. Bo Blackshear, defensive tackle, was out. Chance Waz played with a neck injury. Orion Stewart, a safety, was out. Alfred Pullum, a corner, was out. Terrell Burt, a safety, was out.
And what I like the most about Chris Johnson's performance as a third string quarterback, he came into the game when they needed him, and he was prepared.
He was prepared, and he played with confidence, which is so difficult to do when you don't have the reps to back that confidence up. What a performance.
So how about this? For the first time since 1939, Baylor comes into Stillwater and wins. 45-35, the final. They do it with a backup quarterback, Chris Johnson. Saves the day for Art Briles, and the Bears hand the Cowboys their first loss of the season. Let's go downstairs where our Molly McGrath is standing by with Art Briles.
All right, thanks, Gus. Coach, some congratulations going around. Your team has dealt with adversity all season. Another quarterback, Jarrett Stidham, goes down with injury. How happy are you with how Chris Johnson responded?
You know, I'm just happy for our football team. You know, we have faced a lot of adversity, and we just, you know, we talked about being a tough team, and that's something we wanted to be and come in here and just play tough, you know, just grind, never play, and everybody had a chance to help, they helped. I thought Jarrett was unbelievable in the first half. Chris was unbelievable second half. I thought our defense played great. Just good special teams. Just a great team win, honestly.
Your third-string quarterback goes in, and the success of your offense now lies on the shoulders of your offensive line. What did they do well to help you guys get this win?
All those guys are old. You know, they played a bunch of games. They've won a bunch of football games, you know, and won two championships. So you know, we leaned on them. They played well. They responded well. And, you know, I'm proud of our team. They did a great job tonight.
In the Big 12, November is all about wins over quality opponents. You definitely did that tonight. How will this give you momentum going into next week in Fort Worth?
Well, I mean, you know, we got 6 days. We got to travel home tonight, go to work tomorrow, then travel to Fort Worth Friday. But, you know, we'll be ready. We got a good football team.
All right. Congratulations, Coach. Back to you, Gus.
All right, Molly. 45-35. Baylor defeats Oklahoma State, and the Bears are still alive for their third straight Big 12 title. We'll be back to Stillwater.